Greece's third with international creditors since 2010. By contrast, Tsipras suffered the biggest rebellion yet among anti-bailout lawmakers from his leftist Syriza party, forcing him to consider a confidence vote that would pave the way for early elections if he loses. Opinion polls show Tsipras remains popular even though he presided over the closure of banks for 3 weeks, the imposition of capital controls, and a near brush with financial collapse. This has raised doubts about how much the opposition parties may want to force new elections. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A report on obesity rates released this week by the CDC confirmed that millions of courageous Americans continue to overcome the media's persistent pressure to be thin. Researchers told reporters that while the vast majority of film and television continues to portray thin, in-shape people, over 30% of Americans remain resolved in their effort to stand up to idealized images of men and women.
Every day, people are inundated with unvarying images of slim men and women, but millions of heroic Americans continue doing their best every day to maintain BMIs 35 or higher. These people aren't afraid to fly in the face popular culture deems acceptable and bravely eat and drink whatever they want, whenever they want.
In other news, the nation's single men announce a plan to change their bedsheets by 2019. A woman who left the room crying earlier expects to jump back into the party just like that. And a courtroom artist is clearly infatuated with the bailiff. This 2.5 minute long session of immersion therapy is finally complete. Your crippling fear of watching video news recaps should no longer be a problem. For more, keep checking theonion.com.
Join us here on the radio waves, and we'll give you the number here in just a moment. You can also Skype into the show with you in the studio this evening. It's Ian,
Derrick J,
and Mark.
And of course, you can join us online anytime you want over at freetalklive.com. So please go there and enjoy the various features that we have waiting for you coming up here tonight. Derrick J and Mark both happen to have similar kind of stories about crowdfunding for public goods, as some might say. And apparently there's one state legislator down in Alabama that Mark wants to tell us about who's trying to crowdfund for the state budget as well. So we can talk about those things. But first, let's go to the phones and to the fun, where we've got Drew on our Skype line. Skype is, by the way, username lrn.fm. Drew in Des Moines, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Derrick J, and Mark.
Hey, I'll kind of lead up to my question. I hear you guys talking a lot about the police and the state and how the criminals, and when they do things that break the law, they get put in a cage. So I kind of understand how in a free society, there's not going to be laws. So there won't be people breaking laws, and kind of the voluntary interaction will take care of the people that, you know, if someone does something that you don't like, you won't interact with them.
Well, I got to say, I don't know if there won't be laws. I mean, I think there are certain natural laws that always must be adhered to, like, you know, do no harm. Don't aggress against another person. Don't use the threat of violence or force to achieve your goals in life. I think that there will be, I think that'll be codified in some way, shape, or form. I mean, even though most people inherently know that, if a law is some sort of opinion written down on paper that is widely acceptable in a free society, I think, you know, most people would be not favorable towards people murdering and raping and pillaging. So I think that there would be general rules that that people would follow at, you know, various different people's property and businesses, that if you want to call them laws, you probably could, I think, in that. But, you know, in the traditional sense, that there would be some sort of legislature defining statutes with code numbers, I sure do hope we can get away from that, because nobody can possibly know what those laws are. They can't know, even though they're told ignorance of the law is no excuse. Everybody's ignorant of the law, including the people who enforce it. In fact, very frequently, the people who enforce those laws show how ignorant that they are. So I don't know. I don't think it's really fair or accurate to say there would be no laws in a free society. There would certainly still be rules on private property, and I'm sure some people would still call that the law.
Yep, that's kind of where my question was going, as you kind of touched on, like, the murderers and the rapists. In a free society, how are those kind of people dealt with? Like, now they go to prison, but in a free society, would there be a prison, or how would that be handled?
How would you like them to be handled, Drew?
I can't really think of anything different than sending them to a place like a prison, but that doesn't really, in my mind, that doesn't really mesh with a free society.
Well, I think that there'll probably be things that are like prisons. If there's people that cannot be with other people, people who are fundamentally and inherently antisocial, then
dangerous.
Dangerous. And by antisocial, I mean dangerous, that can't be with other people. Those people are going to have to be someplace where they can't get out. I don't know what that, I don't know how that place is going to be, but I can tell you that essentially a group of people now claim to have dominion over the rest of us. And if they think we are sufficiently antisocial, they'll lock us away. Those group of people have as much legitimacy as me when I claim I am your king, Drew. And they have that much legitimacy. Like, they're just people who claim to be able to do what they do. And so people that claim to be able to do that in a free society will probably do that too. They'll say, look, we got to lock this person away. He or she is dangerous. I don't know exactly. I'm not going to say prisons don't exist. I will, however, put a little spin on it. If there's somebody who's, say, most crimes have a victim. Most real crimes have a victim. Those victims could be made whole in some way by a certain amount of money. And if the prison could, say, put somebody to work and, manage those people's pay so that they can then pay back the victim, if that's the whole purpose of the prison, like, maybe you can get out of prison early if you work harder to do a better job of paying your victim back.
That makes sense.
Like, if you're sentenced to $100,000 and it takes you 10 years to produce $100,000, then you get a 10-year sentence. If it takes you 1 year to produce $100,000, you get a 1-year sentence. I don't know precisely, but this is sort of an interesting take on it, and it certainly does a better job of making the victim whole. A lot of people would say, but then Bill Gates would turn into a mass murderer. and I don't have a good solution for that. I suspect
is if there's someone who's a clear and present danger, then you keep that person locked away, right? Like, if they've murdered people, then that's a good reason to say, okay, well, there is no amount of money that you can just pay somebody. You've taken someone's life. That's not, I don't think anybody would say that another person's life is worth just $100,000.
I don't know.
If you've got somebody who's done some damage to another person and it's something they regret, one time it was a crime of passion or something like that, that person could probably get out after making some sort of good. But if you've got a murderer who's a serial murderer, I can't imagine anybody is going to support letting that person out.
In a free society, may they not decide that some lives are worth more than others? Like, for instance, the father that kills the rapist of his daughter.
Mm-hmm.
That rapist may be considered to be less valuable than, say, the father of the hardworking father of a family. I don't know the answer. And
you'll have to get murderer's insurance.
Yep. I'm sure that you would have to have some kind of insurance against that. Supposedly we have it now. They call it law enforcement, but it's not very effective.
Well, so this is obvious to me that there's going to be a lot of market demand for locking away murderers. We don't really want people. Most people don't want murderers out on the street. And so that's an economic opportunity for an entrepreneur when there's finally a free market in a free society to say, hey, there's this problem that everyone wants solved. I'll bet I could make a lot of money if I offer some solutions for that. But right now we have the state, and the state just gives us their one solution. It's been the same for thousands of years, and it's not working so well.
And it would be nice to be able to choose what you think the best option is.
Prisons haven't been around for thousands of years. They're extraordinarily expensive solutions. They've had dungeons, but mostly they chop people's hands off or heads off if they were a problem. They turned them into slaves or, a variety of things.
I wouldn't pay for what's going on now. Let me put it that way.
You are, though. Lots and lots.
Drew, any other thoughts you want to share? Go ahead.
Well, Derrick kind of touched on another question I was going to ask about privatizing sort of the prisons, or in a free society, the entrepreneur could, start his own prison and then but where would the incentive, or where would his funding, or where would his income, what would be the source of his revenue to
that's a good question.
That prison operating?
I would say it would come from the prisoners themselves, who are, you know, would be given opportunities to work in there. And, of course, they could also gather funds in a variety of other ways that we probably can't even think up yet.
Sure. I could envision another way where there's an insurance against certain types of crimes in an area.
And so the insurers pay for it?
Yeah. And so you would say, hey, I want insurance against this sort of crime. And if anything were to happen, then your insurance company takes care of the punishment.
Also,
makes sense.
I do, for a living, I sell radio ads for this show. I could do my job from essentially a desk and a telephone. It wouldn't make a difference whether I was in prison or out. And mm-hmm. there's certainly jobs that can be done by prisoners that are out there that I mean, they can be doing farm work. They can be doing a variety of things that they're not doing now. Having been in prison, I can tell you there's an extraordinary amount of time spent counting bodies.
Hey, thanks for the call tonight, Drew. Good questions. Appreciate it. Our toll-free number, if you want to join us to talk about the future of imprisoning people, it's not a not a happy topic to discuss here, but I think that future would involve imprisoning far fewer people, considering that the future that we envision, I think, and I think I can speak for all three of us, doesn't involve an insane war on drugs and other victimless crimes that are currently littering our prisons with all manner of innocent people who've never harmed another human being. So if we can whittle it down to just having to imprison the people who are psychopaths like Charles Manson, then, you know, I don't think it would cost as much to run those prisons. But let's talk more about the cost, because what if the prisoner doesn't want to work? Because there are going to be those guys. 855-450-FREE.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
Thousands of people seeking home security get ripped off every day, and the home security industry wants you to believe that's your only option. They've got hordes of salesmen out there trying to scare you into signing one of their long-term contracts. You get stuck writing huge checks month after month with no way out. It's robbery by contract, and it can cost you thousands. But there's a better way to protect your home. SimpliSafe Home Security. SimpliSafe has no contracts. None. You'll get award-winning 24/7 protection. Security professionals watching over your home, ready to instantly send police to the rescue. For just $14.99 per month. That's less than half what most companies charge. Protect your home the smart way. Visit SimpliSafeDefense.com today for an exclusive 10% offer and get a free keychain remote worth $25. Only when you go to SimpliSafeDefense.com. SimpliSafeDefense.com.
You can't win if you don't enter, and you actually can improve your chances of winning a prize drawing if you wrinkle up your entry blank. I'm Holland Cook from SurvivalSpeech.com, and I speak from experience. Why this works? If they'll be spinning the drum before drawing, your entry blank will move around more than, and not adhere to, other perfectly flat entry blanks. And if they don't spin the drum and merely reach into a box full of other perfectly flat entry blanks, many of which are sticking together, yours will feel different to the person reaching in. When you win, act surprised. And if you're looking for work, this is a metaphor. For more tips on sticking out in a world where just too much blends into the blah, 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 hit SurvivalSpeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live. You can, of course, join us here toll-free. You can bring up anything you want. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us online over at freetalklive.com. If you're getting online, you care about privacy, you need Pro XPN. I just put it on a notebook computer today, as a matter of fact, working with Windows 10. It also works with Mac, iOS, Android, as well as Linux. So you can go and get started for free at proxpn.com right now. But when you're ready to sign up for their premium account, you can use code FTL50, and you'll be able to save 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of your account when you buy an annual account with that code, FTL50, and that brings the price down to less than a good cup of coffee. Go and get started at proxpn.com. They do it all right. It is an open VPN, the gold standard of network encryption, a virtual private network that encrypts your online data before it even reaches your internet service provider. So get started at proxpn.com right now and use code FTL50 and take back the privacy that is your right. Before we go on with the calls here and your thoughts, I did want to get the question out about, well, what if a prisoner doesn't want to pay? Because we talked about the idea of not government-run prisons in some sort of free society in which we'd hope to inhabit someday. The idea of the marketplace, if you will, providing these services, which is hard to really imagine. But the proposal was put on the table, the idea that the prisoners themselves could help fund the operation of the prison by working. And that would also allow the prisoner to take a little nest egg home for themselves when they're done with prison. So the prisoner saves, I'm just throwing numbers out, a third of the paycheck. The prison itself gets a third of the paycheck for overhead, and the victim gets a third of the paycheck for restitution. That's just some random numbers there. So then, you know, after the fact, what if the person isn't willing to work? What if they say, the hell with you, I don't regret what I did, and I'm not going to help you build these walls around me? Then what should happen to that person?
Well, I think that these organizations, these private prisons, whatever they might be, these private work programs, these, incarceration to freedom programs, whatever one might call them, they're going to have to keep people inside, right? Like, mm-hmm. There's going to be some people that can't go outside to work. They have to stay inside to work.
Right.
And so they're going to have, guards, right? People with a perimeter. There's going to be a geographic area, and people are going to have to stay inside that area. I imagine they'll build a fence. The fence will have motion detectors. Around the fence will be guards. Now, I would suspect that at their lowest service level, that there probably wouldn't be much service going on inside, right? Like, this is just, hey, we just have a perimeter here, mm-hmm. and you stay inside the perimeter. We don't go in to protect you. We don't do anything. You're just in there. And we don't even move food in. You want food? Well, you're going to have to pay for that. That's part of the whole deal here. And, well.
Well, I mean, you can't starve somebody, Mark. So
you can give them a bag of seeds when they go in.
Right.
Beans are cheap.
Yeah, I think that the answer to the question is that they would obviously be allowed to pay their way if they were independently wealthy. But if not, they'd get subsistence level food. So if you work for the work program, you get better food, right? Like, you're treated better, you get a better existence on the inside. They get no privileges, they get, you know, the cheapest level of food, and they have to rely on the charity of others. So, like, there's, you know, probably going to be some group out there that feels really bad for all of these recalcitrants who are refusing to actually pay back their victims, and they might donate to some sort of fund that will help keep those guys fed. But, you know, I agree with the beans idea.
I think I've got it. It's better than both Ian's prison and Mark's prison idea, and I'm going to compete with both of you on the free market of the future here with my idea, which is going to be cheaper, safer, and, you know, more interactive, because I want to shoot these people with an RFID dart that tracks them and just say, you're free to go. Go anywhere you want. You don't want to pay back your restitution to the person you've wronged. And then I'll publish the RFID locations on a website that anyone can go and track them and do whatever they want with these people. They've got the history of them, some ID, and a reward.
Yeah, but they can go take it out. They'll go to some underground doctor and have that sucker ripped out of there.
There's probably, if they...
But there will be a reward for those doctors, right? So if they'd have to go to the wrong person, right? Mm. So it makes life very difficult if they want to make life difficult for others. All I want to do is watch you, have you on my website so people know where you are and what you're doing. We know about your crimes. I think it would be a good solution, because I'm for freedom. I want people to be free. You do something wrong, you've got an opportunity to make it right. But if you choose not to make it right, well, I want people to know who you are, what you've done, and where you are.
Of course, RFID doesn't necessarily transmit a location, so you would have RFID receiving devices around everywhere in order to get any kind of idea of where.
Well, we already have those. We already have RFID receiving devices everywhere, and CVSs, every store you walk into has them. I'll bet this could be incorporated with the mainstream businesses.
Now, are you suggesting that people like vigilante justice would solve the problem? Like,
it's not the same.
This guy's a murderer, and now he might be out on the streets looking to kill again.
It's not the same thing as vigilante justice for CVS to have a contract with a company like this that says, hey, you know, when this person comes into our store, when this RFID goes off in our doors, we're just going to pull a silent alarm and have you know, your people show up.
It sounds like a big cost in the long run, though.
Why is that such a big cost? They've already got all the equipment already.
Yeah, but, you know, then you've got you've got to bring the security team in every time this guy goes to the store. I mean, it's just...
You don't have to bring a security team in. Just one guy. Or just notify the website. Let people know where he is.
Yeah, I think that there, if the crime is sufficiently bad, I think that there'll be people who are interested in, you know, some level of justice for somebody who doesn't want to make good in any way, shape, or form. I don't know. I'm not saying
vigilante justice. Right, like that would be something the system encourages.
What justice is different than vigilante justice? Vigilante is a term
that you put in front
of the word justice to describe it as something different than the justice that we get today. I would like to use the term justice that we get today in quotation marks.
Yes,
because
that's
it's
good.
Nothing
I'm
like
you.
Justice.
Well, I wouldn't call it vigilante justice. I think these people would probably be professionals, similar to what bounty hunters are today, but without the support and backing of the law.
You can share your thoughts. What about what do you think about Derek's idea? Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, or Mark's or myself, 855-450-3733. You can bring up anything. Libertarian Banker calling from Anonymous. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, guys. I just want to move from the future of prisons into the future of money, which I believe is Bitcoin.
Yes.
So everybody these days is talking about frictionless payments. Whether it's Apple Pay or some type of RFID scanner that will allow your payment to go through without any swiping of the card. And I think Bitcoin is primed to take this position here because of the financial transaction system that's inherent in Bitcoin.
What is Bitcoin?
Bitcoin, I call in and talk about it all the time. I keep forgetting your listeners don't know. Bitcoin is a virtual currency in a financial transaction system that is competing with the U.S. dollar, and I think will eventually beat it. It's a stateless currency, not owned by any government, and it is the future of money, in my opinion.
Let's talk about this frictionless payment idea here. Stand by, Libertarian Banker, and if you want to join us, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We do love talking about Bitcoin, I have to say.
I'm a big fan.
Great topic. All of us are big fans. 855-450-FREE. Also, join us via Skype. Skype username's lrn.fm, and this is Free Talk Live.
In recent years, we have witnessed the most catastrophic disasters in history. Earthquakes, hurricanes, tornadoes, typhoons, and more. Legacy Premium Food Storage will prepare you. Our great-tasting, non-GMO quality food products have a 25-year shelf life, are the most affordable on the market, and are American-made. They're perfect for hiking, camping, and road trips, too. Be prepared with the best. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. That's SurvivalFoodAlliance.com.
KDArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order, KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
Free Talk Live.
What is your goal? What do you want of this revolution that you speak of?
You got to stir things up enough so the people will actually revolt in a big way.
And what will that result
in? Millions of people in the streets, you know, and the military guys ain't going to like it.
So what is your goal? You don't really know, do you? You don't really know what you want besides chaos.
A bloody revolution in the streets is the only way.
You want a bloody revolution? This is why I don't want to associate with people like you. Thank you for the call. You're dangerous and crazy, in my opinion, if you're talking about bloody revolution. Violent revolution just results in more violence in the future because the people who were the most violent are the ones that rise to power in whatever new power structure is created after the revolution's all over and done with, after the blood has spilt. Whoopee-doo, you've changed out one gang of criminals for another gang of thugs.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at lrn.fm.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Monday, gold is $7 higher at $1,121 per ounce. Silver is up 10 cents at $15.40 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $256. Robertson Roberts has been helping people with buying and selling precious metals for nearly 40 years. If you would like more information, give us a call, 800-874-9760, or visit our website at rrbi.co.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Hi, I'm Derrick J. I don't want a politician to represent me. To me, government is the idea that one group of people can coerce everyone to comply with an edict or face increasing punishments up to and including death. Despite perhaps the most noble of intentions, the best government services are a far cry from what could be provided for by voluntary interactions. Besides, the people who call themselves the government wage wars and put peaceful people in jail for crimes involving no victims. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derrick J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at VictimlessCrimeSpree.com. That's VictimlessCrimeSpree.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Join us toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Whether it's Bitcoin or prison in a free society, sounds a little contradictory. You can share your thoughts, 855-450-FREE, or Skype into the show, username LRN.FM. Speaking of Bitcoin, Mark, where would one go to get some Bitcoin news and such?
Bitcoinist.net. They are the ultimate resource for Bitcoin industry news and reviews, education, and the latest in the cryptocurrency ecosystem. Whether you are a beginner or an expert, they make it easy for you. They've got sophisticated Bitcoin network statistics, a solid beginner's guide to Bitcoin, and a lot more over there. Also, fintech and blockchain tech news as well. Breaking Bitcoin and digital currency news. Bitcoinist is the one-stop shop, whether you're a beginner or an expert. Bitcoinist.net.
All right, let's go back to Libertarian Banker, calling from somewhere he'd rather not say. So you were just getting into the idea of Bitcoin, a decentralized currency issued by neither a bank or a government. It's become arguably the world's most valuable currency. And go ahead with your thoughts. Why were you calling about Bitcoin tonight?
Well, I have to say, you in the introduction there, you said something about prisons and Bitcoin being contradictory. But maybe the prisoners could earn Bitcoin while they're in prison.
No, I'm saying it sounded contradictory to have prisons in a free society. That's what I was referring to. But yes, certainly Bitcoin in prison is a fine idea.
Very good. Well, but my point today was about frictionless payments, and a lot of people love these. And what frictionless payments is like Apple Pay or any type of payment where you don't create friction, I guess. There's no rubbing of a magnetic strip.
Waiting for change and handing over currency.
Well, exactly. But credit cards did that same thing, Ian. And those are still friction payments.
Right.
What I mean is wireless sort of near field communication type payments like Apple Pay and Google Wallet.
Isn't friction more of a metaphor?
Yeah, I thought friction meant that it was just difficult, and it is difficult to be set up to do credit card payments. You know, as a vendor, you got to go out, you got to get the machine, you got to pay all kinds of money on a monthly basis.
I think it means frictionless for the customer, not for the
vendor. Yeah, the customer drives the payment industry. The merchants just follow what the customers want to do. But so frictionless payments, meaning, there's not friction. So the swiping the card is now considered a friction payment. Frictionless would be when you buy something on Amazon with your iPhone, you stick your finger on the Touch ID to authorize it. And there's no entering the credit card number or swiping or anything. It's very easy. So like you said, the ease of which to make the payment. And there's actually a thing nowadays, I don't know, everybody's getting these new credit cards in the mail that have the chip in them. And I don't know about you guys, but if you've used that thing, it's like twice as long as swiping the daggone card.
Really?
So, last time I used it, it took about 25 seconds to actually authorize and everything. So,
that's crazy. Where do you actually use one of these things? I mean, is there like some sort of point of sale that makes it obvious?
Well, all of the machines by October 1st have to be upgraded new chip card technology.
So every point of sale, there's some sort of federal regulation that's mandating every point of sale credit card device has to have this near field communication.
Yeah, and we're way behind Europe, who's had this for like 10 years.
And they will still take both. So you'll notice on the machine, there's still the way to swipe the magnetic strip as well as insert this. So they're going to be kind of running both together for a little while until people get used to it. Hmm. But you're right there, Jay. We're way behind Europe in that sense. They've been using it for almost a decade now, and it prevents fraud in a lot of different ways. But my point really was about Bitcoin and how it is poised, I think, to be the ultimate frictionless payment. I mean, I honestly have never owned or used a Bitcoin. I have studied it and have friends that have done so, but from what I can tell, it's very laborious to send a Bitcoin now, but it could.
No,
it's not that hard. Tell you what, you go to blockchain.info, open up a Bitcoin account, send me an email. I'll send you some Bitcoin.
Yeah, it's really super simple. I'm actually shocked that you're so knowledgeable about Bitcoin, but yet have never even tried
haven't had a need. I have not had a need to have Bitcoin.
Curiosity?
You must not need 20% off at Amazon or 20% off your next Starbucks, because you can do that with Bitcoin.
Hey, you know, if you can get my wife to start using Bitcoin, I'll take it.
Well, I don't know your wife, so you're going to have to work on that one on your own. Thanks, Libertarian Banker. Appreciate it. Here's what you can do.
Yet another kept man in America. I swear to God that we are the vestigial gender. We are little more than dogs on leashes.
Speak for yourself. But that is a gay man. That's crazy.
You don't have a wife.
I've heard him call in so many times talking about Bitcoin. It really does... I don't know if surprise is even the right word.
You've had a man on a leash, sir. I have seen that happen.
And I speak from experience.
You were not on the leash, though, right?
Well, we switched.
Oh, you did? Okay. Yeah. Okay. Sorry. What were you saying about Bitcoin?
That it's amazing to me. Yeah. It literally takes less than a minute to set up a Bitcoin wallet.
Right.
And it's free, and it doesn't require any personal information. So
someone
who's got even just the slightest bit of knowledge, if they want to share this, if they want to promote it and say, hey, you should check out Bitcoin, start by getting your own wallet. See how easy it really is, and then you can evangelize from a better standing point.
So Roger Veer has been recommending a wallet that is called Lux Stack.
Okay.
And I have not had a chance to actually use it. I installed it on my phone, and it told me when I ran it that I could not run LuxStack on my phone because my phone is rooted, and you're not supposed to do that with your phone, and there's maybe some sort of security issue with rooted phones, so it refuses to run on my phone. But Roger Veer really loves it. The other one for Amazon or for Android is Bitcoin Wallet. When you search for Bitcoin Wallet, it's called Bitcoin Wallet. It's the first thing that comes up. That's the one, Derrick J., you and I were recommending to people at the fair. For iPhone, Derrick was recommending the Bread Wallet.
Yeah.
The Blockchain.info's got a good iPhone wallet, though. That one is good, but the Blockchain wallet on Android is absolutely god-awful. And so there's some ups and downs to some of these wallets out there, but they are all free, and you can probably find one that really works well for you. Airbits is also an excellent wallet. I did finally get that reinstalled, and it's been working since then.
Excellent.
So those are some suggestions. But if you want, you can go to bitcoin.com and you can learn more about Bitcoin there. It's simple, bitcoin.com. You also mentioned saving 20%, right? You want your wife to come on board with Bitcoin. Just go home and tell her to go to purse.freetalklive.com and she can save 20% or more off of her Amazon purchases. And this new thing with Starbucks, 20% off of Starbucks. What are there? Millions of people every day that go to Starbucks. Who wouldn't want 20% off on a daily basis? You can do that with the Fold app. And I believe that is coffee.foldapp.com.
I get why people would, if you're going to go to Starbucks, you should save 20%. But the fact is, go to Amazon, go to purse.freetalklive.com and buy your coffee online on Amazon there. Get better coffee, or at least as good a coffee. Mm-hmm. If you're a big Starbucks fan, you can get that kind of heavily roasted coffee there on Amazon and save a lot of money by brewing it yourself.
Oh, it's apples and oranges. I mean, having a coffee made for you is a service that Amazon just can't provide.
Yeah, sometimes you want to go out with somebody. You don't want to just necessarily sit at home with them.
Sometimes
you
need real estate to sit in a certain spot. There's no doubt about that.
Let's go to Michael. He's in Texas. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Derrick J., and Mark. Hello, Michael.
Hi, guys.
Hey.
Not really why I called, but real quick, I do agree with what Derrick J. was saying about the prisoners, about putting an RFID chip in them or some kind of GPS tracking. It kind of seems like an additional, I've heard Stephon Molyneux talk about it, like, the dispute resolution things where, like, you have an insurance policy that, when you try to rent a house or buy food somewhere, you know, it's a reason for somebody not to sell to you because, you know, you're a menace to society.
Yeah, you would become an outlaw, really, essentially, in a situation like
that. Yeah, that's not really why I called, but...
All right, well, stand by for the real reason that you called. More with Michael, and your calls and thoughts are also welcome. Please join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Also, still to come... The crowdsourced government budget, it's actually happening, and I don't know if it's good news. Mark will tell us more about that. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it.
You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Everyone says or does something silly once in a while. But once that embarrassing thing is on the internet, it can spread like a terrible rash. Put it to rest. Get a free expert analysis today from Reputation.com. It only takes 30 seconds. 800-831-0771. We protect your online image by helping to make sure that when people search for you or your business, they find the most current, accurate information possible. Reputation.com. Because word travels fast. Call for a free analysis today. 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Due to an upturn in the economy, Main Street Business Loans has pre-approved the release of millions of dollars in small business funding. Your business may already be pre-approved to receive up to $250,000. We've sent out millions of pre-approval letters. We see the economy growing, and our underwriters believe now is the time to invest in your business so you can grow faster and make more money. And we're prepared to give you up to $250,000 to do it. Your funds can be available in 5 days. There are no application fees, no annual fees, just quick access to up to $250,000. If your business did not receive your approval letter to get up to $250,000, call Main Street Business Loans Approval Desk now.
800-430-4505. 800-430-4505. 800-430-4505. That's 800-430-4505.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
If you want to move to the free state, and you're looking for some real estate.
Oof, I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you? If you're going to invest in property in New Hampshire, it just makes sense to support a liberty-friendly realtor. Call Mark Warden of Team Porcupine Real Estate for investment property or rentals in the free state, or visit his website. Come on, you know it.
PorcupineRealEstate.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in and join us here, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Skype on in here. Skype username is lrn.fm. Joining you in the studio, it's Ian.
Derrick J.
And Mark.
You want more Derrick J? You can go and get a bunch of Derrick J over at thederrickj.com. Did I hear that you were adding some content recently, Derrick J?
Oh, man. So much content has been added, and more is on the way. Yeah, I just started a new RSS feed, lots of podcast stuff going on. So if people like hearing about stories of police abuse and being held accountable. You can listen to that over at TheDerrickJ.com.
Also,
Cop-Block Radio.
A super gay radio show called Flaming Freedom.
Yeah, Flaming Freedom is at the top of TheDerrickJ.com right now. And I've combined them all into one podcast feed. So if people want all the things that I'm doing, including Free Talk Live and Freedom Fiends, that now exists on a podcast feed.
So you can get everything that Derrick J is involved with. Just go to TheDerrickJ.com. As we go back to your calls and thoughts, Michael in Texas, you were getting to the point of what you were really calling about. So go ahead with that.
I don't know about everybody else, but you know, me specifically, I don't generally think of Mark as being like an activist. I don't hear much about that, but I mean, I was really surprised because today I watched the YouTube video where he was talking about, I mean, he was in front of the, I think it was the Keene City Council, about the tax exemption for the church.
The tax assessment board. Mark's an activist. He just does more behind-the-scenes stuff than some of us do.
Yeah, I work, usually within sort of the inside-the-system activism, political stuff, that kind of thing.
Yeah, I mean, usually we see, like, Ian and Derrick J on the videos for Free Keene and...
Yep, they like the cameras.
You know, stuff like that, so...
I really don't.
Well, I mean, I think Mark did pretty good. I mean, I really felt like he really stuck it to him that, you know, for like the last decade, you know, y'all say work within the system, we've worked within the system, and look where we're at, and they still denied you.
Yeah, you're referring to the Shire Free Church. There was a hearing on the parsonage.
Yeah.
Here in Keene, it was, you know, we were applying for tax exemption, and of course we knew it was going to be denied. So, Mark, you got up there and gave an impassioned 5 or so minute long speech.
Did you honestly know ahead of time that it was going to be denied? Like, you had foreknowledge, or you
no,
just
I mean,
presumed?
We just
I
know.
Didn't. I got my hopes up. I always get my hopes up. I'm so naive. You know, when I'm watching this video, it was really sad to me that they denied the exemption from the tax status, because I thought, well, the first time, yeah, but the second time, come on, this is when they're going to let it slide. And Mark, you gave such a rousing appeal. I really thought
no
they would
appeal.
Listen to
I was
you.
Telling them that they were terrible people because they will never approve us.
Well, maybe appeal isn't the right word, but I enjoyed it and I thought it was great.
They've done nothing but abuse their power the whole time regarding the activists in Keene, and that it's transparent to anybody who takes a look. And so I just listed off the litany of things that they've done over time and said, go ahead and deny us because you're going to do it anyway.
They have to.
It's
and
so
we're
going
to take it to court, and I have no choice but to enjoy the fact that we're going to take it to court. It's funny that you people's bias drives you to deny us and then to leech your taxpayers some more
to pay for the court costs,
to fight
the
us.
Attorney's fees, which inevitably will not be a cheap thing. They'll probably get if we continue to pay the tax bill in the meantime, they'll probably spend far more than we would pay in taxes on these attorneys than otherwise.
Here's why I thought it was so sad. It was like a man explaining to a ball rolling down a hill, like, you're going to fall down this hill. You're going to just go down and you're going to roll. It's going to, topple. It's going to go reach the bottom. And it's like, but these are human beings. You know, they're not deterministic machines, but they act like it.
Yep,
that's what's
like
so
it.
Sad.
Well, they're doing their job, Derrick J., and their job is to protect the state. It's not to give people tax exemptions. It's to refuse to give them tax exemptions. Then, so that person then has to go and fight and spend thousands of dollars in court at a chance at having their decision overturned, which it may eventually be overturned.
But by the friends of these people?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah, sure, that's likely.
I wouldn't expect it to happen necessarily, but the chances are better in a court because the judge would, in theory, understand the freedom of religion better. And the various court cases out there.
Where are his incentives? Can he be taken off the bench?
No.
Well, then he has no incentive to.
His only incentive is to do the right thing because he could be overturned. And in this particular case, this particular judge did do the right thing in the Robin Hood case, which he didn't want to be overturned. So
nothing
he made
even
the right
happens.
Choice.
Overturned. That sounds like his table gets knocked over. He falls out of his chair or something. Nothing happens to him. It's oops. He doesn't even probably get a letter in the mail saying, "Oh yeah, that decision you made was wrong." No one even talks about it at lunch behind the counters.
I think he knows.
Nothing happens.
I think those judges know when they get overturned.
I'm sure they get real
court.
Embarrassed. Yeah, they have to drink their sorrows away.
Well, I have heard that Judge Burke does go and buys alcohol from a certain convenience store.
I'm sure he would do that regardless on the weekend. His bad decisions.
This is, you have no idea. Somebody has said something to you. That's a terrible thing to spread that kind of rumor. I've heard all kinds of terrible rumors about you, too.
It was my celly in jail.
It's none of your
business.
So
he's more credible.
And he said he used to work at Romy's Market, and he actually sold him the alcohol. I mean, it's still hearsay.
So what? Ridiculous.
It's certainly fine. Judge Burke is free to drink himself into oblivion on the weekend.
I guess the point Ian is making is that they'll face natural consequences if not contrived government.
If he wants
ones.
To make the point that somebody who is sending people to jail for using drugs uses a drug, I'm fine with that.
That's
but
certainly a
to
point.
To suggest that somebody who is purchasing alcohol is somehow a drunk is ridiculous.
I heard he was drunk when he came in.
None of your business. And that's someone's assessment that works behind the counter
that's
at a
true.
Convenience store.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. But I imagine he would sell the alcohol to him. Because aren't you supposed to refuse sales if somebody is too S-faced?
I don't know what the rules are. I wouldn't
sure
obey them.
Michael, anything else you want to share tonight?
No, I just kind of want to commend Mark. I mean, I don't think he gets enough credit for being an activist, and I think that was really cool what
there
he did.
There you go.
Thank you.
Amen. Michael, thanks for the call. Hopefully it will encourage you and others to make the move to New Hampshire as part of the Free State Project. Appreciate your call tonight. You can go to freestateproject.org. Hey, look, I'd be the first to have a drink with Judge Burke. I'm not, you know, trying to act like I'm somehow better or whatever. Yeah, man, I've got a...
You would sit down for a whole 5 minutes with him
I'd
and have a conversation?
I'd sit down for dinner with Judge Burke, absolutely.
In
fact,
in
I invited him out for lunch years ago, Derrick J. I don't know if you knew this, but...
Are you just a glutton for punishment? Do you love uncomfortable conversations? Or what? Like, would you want to do that?
I don't think it would be uncomfortable. I mean, he and I have certainly had plenty of interactions over the years. I think it would be an interesting discussion. I've sat down with the city manager before and the city code enforcer and broken bread with them.
Historic video.
Which one?
The one where you sat down with the city manager, John McLean, with a group of others.
Well, there was that
historic
video, but I actually did have lunch with John McLean as well.
Oh, but you didn't record that.
On a separate occasion. No, that was just a conversation
just
between
regular.
Two men. You know?
Yeah.
So I actually invited Judge Burke out to lunch, I don't know, half a decade ago or something like that, and he initially said yes. But then he kind of blew me off by saying I needed to go through the court clerk, because apparently the court clerk somehow schedules his lunches. I don't know if I believe that, but that was what he said. And so then I, you know, went and talked to the court clerk, and it seemed like something that maybe could happen.
Hey!
But then what happened was I got arrested for something else and got some other charges, and so therefore, you know, you can't go out and have lunch with the judge when you're facing him in court, that kind of thing. So there's that conflict of interest going on. And so that was his excuse for not going to lunch for a little while. And then eventually I got out from underneath those charges and approached him about it when I saw him again in person. And he never says no to going out to lunch. Just never ends up being able
to happen.
Maybe
he just thinks you'll be boring. Maybe he's just not that into you.
All right. So our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. But I don't know. I want to ask him questions, Derrick J. I want to know things about... And maybe he wouldn't be honest with me. I don't know.
Then
but
you
like,
better record it.
You can't do that.
Come on.
You can't do that.
Do it for me. Just do it for posterity.
You can't.
Do it for people who want to hear this conversation 100 years from now when we're all long gone. I mean, that conversation on record would be one of the most fascinating
it would be,
interviews.
People would say things differently if they knew they were on the record.
Yeah, well, you don't tell it.
Then it's wiretapping.
Okay. I say do it.
I've got to say.
And you're wiretapping a judge.
Right. Yep.
I say that's one of the worst suggestions you've had in a long time.
It would be great audio. That's
no
all
doubt.
I'm concerned about.
Of the people that...
You could sit in the corner with a parabolic dish and...
be there.
Of the people you deal with here in the city of Keene, I've got to say one of the ones that I can connect with the most is Judge Burke. I mean, I feel like this guy... attempts to listen and attempts to be fair. Yes, I have seen him in very short-tempered states. No doubt at all. But at the same time, I went in there when you were, you know, your most recent sentencing, and the state was asking for 6 months in jail for you.
Yeah.
And I went to bat for you. The first time I've done this and gone and been a character witness.
It's true.
And he gave you what, 60 days?
I think Judge Burke
suspended?
And I have warmed towards one another
I'm
a
sure
little
that's
bit
all
over
about
the years.
You.
It's Free Talk Live. More coming up.
Breathe it in, kid. Every 3 months, we install these air handler filters. They're more energy efficient, hold more dust, and are priced to save us more money. And Granger's got close to 3,000 different styles and sizes to choose from, in stock and ready when we need them. I love oxygen, kid. And this facility's got some great AO2. I'm breathing easier just thinking about these air handler filters. Get some today. Get it? Got it? Good. Call clickgranger.com/filters or stop by. Granger. For the ones who get it done.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, August 17th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.31 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,119 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $259. Antiwar.com reports, while Iraqi officials continue to downplay the difficulty of turning the tables on the Islamic State, which has captured much of the country's western border with Syria, the government's primary efforts seem to be passing around blame for the major defeats of the war so far. Iraqi Prime Minister Haider Abadi has been loudly critical of the military for the loss of the Anbar capital of Ramadi, saying the troops fled despite orders to stay and defeat the Islamic State. On Sunday, he ordered the commanders court-martialed for abandoning their defensive positions and losing the city. They're not alone in facing blame, however, as the Iraqi parliament has issued a report blaming a number of former government officials, including former Prime Minister Nouri al-Maliki, for the loss of Mosul, the largest city to fall to the Islamic State. In both cases, the underlying assumption is that the battles could have been won if the troops had simply followed the orders to win those battles, and Maliki is facing blame for installing commanders who weren't willing to win the Battle of Mosul. Though it was a surprise how quickly the military lines broke in Mosul, the loss of Ramadi shouldn't have been nearly so surprising, as the poor morale among Iraqi forces was already well documented, and it was clear they simply weren't going to stand up to a sustained the Islamic State offensive.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports at least one person has died so far and many homes have been burned to the ground as four wildfires spread in the western United States. The blazes, burning in drought-ravaged California, Oregon, Washington, and Idaho, have wrought havoc on miles of acreage in recent days. The largest, the so-called Soda Fire, has so far burned nearly 300,000 acres, and the state's Lawyer Complex Fire has so far destroyed more than 50 homes, according to officials. A woman died Friday as she was preparing to flee the wildfire, according to officials, and authorities believe she fell and injured her head. Idaho's governor declared a state of emergency in part of that state. In California, the cabin fire, which was sparked Saturday, is approaching 2,000 acres and is 20% contained. In Oregon, 35,000 acres of land have been torched by the lightning-caused Canyon Creek Complex fire, and more than 100 structures have been destroyed in Washington state. Weather conditions affected by the fires vary across each of the states, and officials said air quality is at its worst levels in some places.
Are you an advocate for free market money? Do you promote Bitcoin as an alternative in a fiat-centric world? Then you need Spendabit in your arsenal, the search engine for things you can buy with Bitcoin. Spendabit aggregates millions of products from thousands of Bitcoin-enabled merchants. Keep your money in the free economy. Visit spendabit.co today. Bitcoin merchants, ask about our merchant suite to reach even more customers. Spendabit.co.
Reuters reports Greece's socialist PASOK party joined the main opposition on Sunday in saying it would not back Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras if he calls a confidence vote following a rebellion in the governing party over a new bailout deal. Tsipras had to rely on opposition groups, including PASOK, to win a parliamentary majority on Friday in favor of the 86 billion euro bailout program, Greece's third with international creditors since 2010. By contrast, Tsipras suffered the biggest rebellion yet among anti-bailout lawmakers from his leftist Syriza party, forcing him to consider a confidence vote that would pave the way for early elections if he loses. Opinion polls show Tsipras remains popular even though he presided over the closure of banks for 3 weeks, the imposition of capital controls, and a near brush with financial collapse. This has raised doubts about how much the opposition parties may want to force new elections. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
The American robin heralds the beginning of spring in temperate climates across North America. Its red breast makes it easily identifiable as the most disturbingly efficient murderer in the animal kingdom. Robins inculcate their young with these twisted maws. We see an adult robin feeding its young with the ripped apart viscerae of an innocent worm. Like the Greek hero Atreus eating the flesh of his children at his own table, this black deed must surely curse the entire species. Even the most depraved acts of humanity pale in comparison to the robin's wickedness. Like idiot rapists, they commit their foul deeds with neither foresight nor hindsight. They live entirely in the present. Living beyond space and time, their god is the awful seething maelstrom of chaos at the center of the unfeeling universe.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to join us here on the radio waves at 855 453. Coming up, some unusual crowdfunding campaigns. Both Mark and Derrick J have a couple different stories. We've also been taking your calls about anything you want to discuss. Our toll-free number again is 855 453. We've got Skype. It's Skype username lrn.fm. Let's go right to the phones, in this case to Skype, where Stefan is on the line in Toronto. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Derrick J, and Mark.
Hi, guys.
Hi, you're on the air.
So I don't know if you remember me. I was on Derek's show a year ago.
Yeah, welcome.
Yeah, and we're talking about psychopaths?
Yes, that's right. There are lots of psychopaths in government. It's one of the biggest problems in the world right now, in my opinion.
Yeah, me too. I agree. That's my opinion too. We were talking about, at the time, well, it's still out there, my video, Defense Against a Psychopath, and it's over 300,000 hits on my channel. I don't know what the other channels are getting on it. So it's doing pretty good. So what I want to talk about today is sort of in line with the previous conversation about psychopaths. I am also, I hate to use the term artist, but, you know, I like to do creative things, so I guess I have to call myself an artist. And I send out proposals to do like public art installations every now and then.
Okay.
And I sent one out to, the last time I did one was, 5 years ago in Ventura, California, where I was living. And that was, a Stonehenge light and sound kind of thing. So anyways, I sent one out to a arts festival here in Toronto. But it's not just here in Toronto. They have these art festivals all over the world. And it's a French term called, and I'm going to bastardize my French pronunciation, so I didn't do too good in grade 6 French class.
The chances of a French person listening are pretty slim.
Okay, then. So I'm off the hook. So it's pronounced Nuit or Nuit Blanc, meaning light or night of the lights. And it's a pretty big deal. They have these art festivals all over the world in big cities like Paris and Amsterdam. And basically what they do is they shut down the center core of the city. And for the entire night, there are art installations on street corners in front of bars and on the middle of the street. They close down the streets. They set up these art installations. And it's a big deal. Last year, we had like 1 million people for this thing, you know. And so I got accepted for my project called Trimonic. Now, I'm going to have to paint you a bit of a picture. Can I do that?
Yeah, sure. What do you do with Trimonic?
Well, Trimonic, it's a play on words. It's a triple or tri and harmonic. Trimonic, if you can imagine this, is 3 12-foot tall black pyramids.
Okay.
And each pyramid is an equilateral pyramid, three-sided, right? 60 degrees on each angle.
Yeah.
And the pyramids are spaced apart so that they form a pyramid on the ground as well. And actually, they also form a pyramid vertically as well. So it's about a 30-foot diameter. Now, the inside of the pyramid, the outside, it's just black. It looks like the monolith from 2001, A Space Odyssey.
Right.
Which is sort of where I got the inspiration for this, among other areas. So on the outside, it's a black pyramid, right? And on the inside, it's curved. So the outside are flat surfaces, but the inside is curved, and it's white. So the trick to this installation is you have to be brave to enter the dark black pyramid. And, of course, the pyramid represents the New World Order and the psychopathic control system, because everything is a pyramid system. You know, the government, the Ponzi schemes, military units, corporate structure, everything is a pyramid. So for those of us who are leaning towards anarchism, we understand the pyramid structure as our enemy. It really is. Because
I've never even thought about it.
Yeah, well, that's how they managed this, you know, and that's why.
Yeah, I happen to agree that at least I don't know about the whole New World Order thing, but I do agree that hierarchies are more problematic than they're worth, and I think that organizational structures should be tried that are different, that get away from hierarchy like that. But you know, if that's how people want to live, certainly they can choose that for themselves.
Well, you know, there's nothing wrong with the pyramid structure itself, other than what happens is, and this is what, going back to our previous conversation, is what happens is whoever's at the top of that pyramid controls the whole game, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, if we have benevolent people at the top of that pyramid and at the upper levels of this pyramid, then we would have just a wonderful, idyllic society.
But
we don't
work out that way.
Yeah.
It doesn't work out that way. So who always ends up at the top of all these hierarchical structures? Who is it that always gets to the top?
Is it
the nicest guy? Is it the one, the most generous guy, the one with the most talent and intelligence? Come on.
No.
Right? Yeah.
It's the power seekers, the people who want to wield force and control over others.
Exactly. So now they're in control of the power structure. So the pyramid on the installation is, you know, this giant pyramid. And it represents everything that's kind of wrong with society. You know, it represents the darkness, the oppression, the police state, the monetary system, the, you know, I call it New World Order, but you can call it any number of things. You know, it's really what's wrong with our society. What's wrong with our society?
So you go and you set this art installation up in different places? Is that right?
Well, this is going to be just for one night here in Toronto, but after I'm done building it for Nuit Blanc. Then I'm going to take it and kind of run it across the country. And my hope is to end up at Burning Man next year.
Oh, yeah. Yay. I was going to say, that sounds like something you might see at a Burning Man. Hey, Robert, thanks. Good luck with Stefan, thank you for the call. Appreciate hearing from you. Good luck with your art project.
Yeah, that sounds pretty cool.
Yeah, it takes all kinds. We've got to have people reaching out in the art world. We've got to have people reaching out in the world of media and people connecting with each other at their workplaces and their churches and talking about the ideas of freedom. Let's go to Robert in Vermont. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Robert.
Thanks for taking my call.
Sure.
Hey, listen, you guys last night, you were talking about some test equipment to be able to test, prescriptions or medications or something.
And we were talking about MDMA, which is commonly known on the streets as ecstasy or Molly. And we were talking about having test equipment for that. Specifically, there's certain chemicals or reagent tests that you can purchase to test MDMA. And there are other ways to test for other drugs. It's just we were specifically talking about MDMA last night.
Right. And that's exactly what I wanted to talk about was that. Is that just for like over-the-counter pills or prescribed pills? Or
MDMA is an illegal drug. MDMA is a narcotic substance as classified by the federal government as I believe a Schedule 1, maybe a Schedule 2 narcotic. It is illegal to possess MDMA, so that's what we're talking about. This has nothing to do with over-the-counter, although we'd like to be able to buy it over-the-counter someday. We're a long way away from that.
Certainly going to be a lot better for people. The black market has all kinds of problems.
Which is why you need a test kit. You certainly don't need a test kit for over-the-counter medication.
Can you test marijuana with that?
No, there are different chemicals. There are tests for marijuana out there. The police, for instance, have them in the back of their police cruiser. They can grab a quickie roadside test, and then they can use it. I don't know how exactly you apply it with the plant matter, but those tests do exist.
I'm asking that because I keep running into where like if somebody will give it to me or if I buy it or something like that. I'm running into where. Sometimes it'll be, they'll put synthetic marijuana into it without my knowledge.
Really? You've actually had that happen and you've been able to confirm that?
It's happened to me twice.
Wow, that sounds dangerous.
Yeah, I would, whoever's doing that, I wouldn't do any business with that person in the future, and that's probably the best way to handle that situation. Robert, thanks for the call tonight. Unless it's an honest mistake and somebody's just passing along product that has been adulterated in some way, unless it was like ground up marijuana, I don't see how you couldn't tell the difference. I mean, the stuff they're selling as synthetic marijuana, it's not like buds of pot. It's just chemical like sprayed on a sort of an herbal mixture typically. So one does not look like the other. A bag of cannabis does not look like the stuff that they're selling as, legal cannabis. You follow me there?
Yeah, I gotcha.
I don't think that it could, side by side, be confusing to people. There's more coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
Olive is a yellow lab, 6 years old, full of energy. But, oh, man, Olive was suffering, to use a word, like a dog. She was itching, she was scratching, she was licking. 24 hours a day, she was shedding all the time. And it drove my wife crazy because she had to vacuum the house a couple times a day. So I'm going up the expressway, and the radio commercial comes on.
Petey stopped eating. All his hair fell out. Mounds and mounds of fur. Our hairballs have hairballs.
And I almost drove off the road because I thought this person on the radio commercial was living with my dog, Olive. And I called my wife. I said, dear, you got to check out this product called Dynavite. Go to dinovite.com. So we started Olive on the Dynavite. In about 6 weeks, she almost has entirely stopped itching, scratching, stopped licking herself. Most of the hair has grown back under her belly. Unexpectedly, her coat has become smooth and shiny, almost like it was when she was a newborn pup. Olive is happy, and my wife is probably the happiest person because the house is cleaner. 859-428-1000. dinovite.com.
dinovite.com.
The Genesis Communications Network is one of America's premier broadcasters of captivating talk radio. We thank you for listening. Now, just imagine, there are thousands of people who are just as passionate about radio as you are. But what you may not realize is how easy and affordable it is to advertise with us. Radio commercials for your business could be heard on hundreds of radio stations across the U.S. every day. We can help you by creating an effective radio advertising campaign for your company. From script writing to producing your commercial, just like the one you're listening to right now, no other network provides the level of customer service we do. When it comes to radio advertising, we are your one-stop shop. And no matter how big or small your business is, we can help. Email us at advertise@gcnlive.com and an experienced advertising executive will help you take the first step towards driving more customers to your business or website. advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free to join us here at 855-450-FREE. Also, that's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Skype on in here at username lrn.fm. We will be discussing the unusual crowdsourcing ideas. One of them, to crowdsource the government's budget. Mark, you've got that story. Let's jump into that shortly, but first, something I want you to know about. If you've been thinking about getting Bitcoin, maybe you want to take advantage of those deep discounts that we talked about earlier at Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com or 20% off of Starbucks. You can do those things with Bitcoin, but you have to get them first. And Express Coin allows you to do that easily. It's safe, it's fast, and it's inexpensive. Bitcoin are available through Express Coin as well as other alternative currencies like Litecoin and Dogecoin. They're a licensed money services business, and you can get your cryptocurrencies with money order or check. Just get started at expresscoin.com. In most of all of the U.S. and Canada, it's expresscoin.com. You can even do it from your smartphone with their app. Use coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live, and you'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no fee at all. Just get started at expresscoin.com, and don't forget coupon code FTL. So, Mark, there's a state representative, is it Alabama or something like that?
I think it's a state senator, actually, that is...
He wants to crowdsource or crowdfund government services?
That's exactly right.
This actually, on its face, sounds like it could be a good idea.
Well, it's a good idea if it would work.
If they would... Well, I think it could work if they'd get rid of taxes. But that's not what he's proposing, is it?
Well, I guess... What he's proposing is to crowdfund the state budget. Mm-hmm. And I would suggest there are two reasons that that his GoFundMe has $578 out of the $300 million that he would like to fundraise.
Almost.
And one of them would be that the services of the state of Alabama are probably not valued that greatly by the Alabamians, right? Like, mm-hmm. they just don't either they sort of feel entitled to whatever the services are that the state provides, or they feel like those services generally stink and they're substandard and they could be done better if only, you know, it was a more efficient allocation of resources and these sorts of things. But I don't think that, you know, I think people are not going to pay as long as they feel like, well, I don't have to pay. It's kind of like public school. The vast majority of parents send their kids to public school. They don't think, not even for a second, that that's the best school in the geographic area known as that district, right?
Mm-hmm.
They don't believe that. They believe that the private schools are better, generally. But they're like, it's good enough. It's fine. And they're willing to send their kid there. It's close. It hits it.
I went there. I turned out okay. That's a common justification.
85% of the job or whatever. They've got higher classes or what? These kind of things. I can personally say as a student who went in eighth grade, I was went to private school and I was on the dean's list. This is the list that's higher than the honor roll. This was a top performing student. I went to public school the next year and failed out of two classes. I'm going to say that the teachers don't care as much. That's just my assessment as a student, you know, some 20-something years ago in public school. And I think that it's a fair assessment. It just seems like the teachers at a private school would care more than the public school teachers, generally, individually.
Do you put that out there because you get a lot of critics saying, like, well, you just don't care about teachers, Mark?
You hear all kinds of things in our line of work, but it's always the rushing to the defense of teachers, it seems like. Like, as though the best way to defend, because teachers are employees who are supposed to teach students to work, but the problem is that they're very controlled employees. They're like hamburger builders at a fast food place. Then you put the bun down, then you put the lettuce down, then you put the mayo down, then you put the bun down, then you put the tomato down, right? Like, they just told exactly what they have to do. They're not teachers. They're assembly line workers, sadly.
Ugh.
And they, they probably went to school to be teachers. They would love to be teachers, but they're not allowed to be teachers.
I'm getting a vision of Pink Floyd's The Wall.
It's a lot like that. So, ultimately, education, for whatever reason, parents choose to send their kid to the substandard school because they've already been forced to pay for it.
Sure.
If they weren't forced to pay for it, they'd probably take the money that they would have paid for it for and got their kid a better education. There'd be competition for that money. We can already see charter schools working for something like $5,000 a term, a year, when the public schools are getting $15,000. They're doing as good, if not a better job, on a third of the price. This is an incredible leap forward, like a being shot out of a cannon, better, but because of the power of teachers' unions and the apathy on the other side, people are just like, oh, I guess there's nothing we can do.
Can't fight City Hall.
Yeah, there's nothing we can do.
But isn't that true?
What's that?
Isn't there nothing they can do to improve government education?
They could pick up and move to a district right nearby and get better education.
What do you mean by that?
Like a better school? Government education?
If there's charter schools nearby, or they could send their kid to a public school, or that one of the parents could they could get into a homeschooling co-op where they work with other parents for different times off, and they could work with other parents to get better education. My kid has this really great education, and we're homeschooling, and we don't even have a curriculum. We're just doing it on our own. Neither one of us is a qualified teacher. Only my wife has a bachelor's, and it's not in teaching. Mm-hmm. I don't even have that. So to say that that's what you need, I mean, come on. A kid gets out of elementary school. You can't teach your kid everything that they need to learn up to elementary school. So I don't know. At the very least, I want my son to have a foundation of how to learn, not how to be told what to do. And that's what you get in public school.
All right. So what's all that have to do with the budget in Alabama?
My bewilderment as to why people would, just prefer to let the state go on and do what it does.
So what's the proposal here? What's going on?
Crowdfunding platform GoFundMe is no stranger to odd requests, but one Southern politician's campaign to solve the state's current financial woes might be a first. As Alabama's government struggles to pass a budget, State Senator Paul Sanford launched a GoFundMe campaign to fund the Alabama state government with $300 million.
Now, that is not their full budget. This is like an overage or something like that. They've budgeted $300 million more than what they're actually taking in. I'm just wondering, where is he getting that $300 million?
Because lobbyists.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean,
he expected his people who usually pay him off to just come up with the regular $300 million, right?
Yeah, that's not their job. Their job is to give you a one-time payment so that they get the law written in their favor.
This is Alabama. It's probably a billion-dollar budget at the very least at the state level. I mean, right here in Little Keene, New Hampshire, the town budget's like $25 or $30 million. So $300 million is probably only a fraction of what it is. So where's it coming from? Does it say?
Well, at this point, it says that they've gotten $600.
I know, but where did he come up with the $300 million?
It's a really big number.
That's what I see here.
I'm just wondering if it's the shortfall between what they are taking in taxes versus what the state is spending. Let's talk more about it.
There's already one person who has put in a $10 contributor with an earmark. He says he wants to be used. He wants this donation to be used for evil and nefarious deeds.
Well, granted.
That's easy.
Yeah. 855-450-FREE. But crowdfunding the government, I think, is actually a pretty good idea. If that's all they were doing, then it'd be voluntary. It's Free Talk Live.
Now a twice-as-nice Twin Kits special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals Twin Kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price, $89.95. But now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the Twin Kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of Ionic Silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Keenvention is coming up October 30th through November 1st. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. Explore Keen, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel from 2013 on. This year, Activist of the Year Daryl W. Perry and Chris Cantwell will be keynoting. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or pay with Bitcoin. That includes access to the Hallo Keene Costume Dance Party. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more speaker announcements or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. Keenvention.info.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I like the idea of crowdfunding a state budget. Unfortunately, I suspect that's not exactly what's going on here with this proposal from a state senator in Alabama. With you in the studio tonight, it's Ian,
Derrick J,
and Mark.
Don't forget you can join us on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. We already told you briefly about Purse earlier. You can go to purse.freetalklive.com and get signed up to ultimately save 20, 25%, maybe even more on the stuff that you're buying on Amazon. Derrick J, what was the last thing you got on Purse? Just curious, if you can tell us.
Face wash,
and that's because you had an absolutely abysmal experience going to a shopping mall recently.
Yeah, you would think a big mall would have face wash that I'm looking for. Even they had it in the tester, but they didn't have it in stock. And so I went to the internet, and the internet had it.
And you got it for less.
I got it for way less, 20% off. Thanks to purse.io.
Was the Amazon price cheaper than the mall price anyway, and then you got 20% off of that?
No, it was 50 cents more.
Ah. So had you not gone with Purse, you would have
actually
been
paying. Actually, no, actually because of the tax that I had to pay because I was in New Jersey. Now I'm in New Hampshire, so it's actually a quarter less. The sticker price was a quarter less being here in New Hampshire. So I saved money just by not going to the store.
And what was the percentage you saved at Purse?
20%.
It was, how long did it take them to fill your order?
2 days.
2 days for 20%. That's a little on the long side.
I think, well, let me see. I think I went through it. I used a gift card for it, so it was a little convoluted, but yeah.
You can save big. Just go to purse.freetalklive.com to get started. The only catch is you got to spend Bitcoin to do it. So, Mark, is there more you can tell me about this? I mean, there's a state senator in Alabama who he's set up a fundraiser on GoFundMe. He wants $300 million. And I'm just curious to know, what is his reasoning for it? I don't know if this news story you have even gets into that.
It does. It's actually okay. The next thing that it talks about. It's from CNN. It says they put up the fund the state government with $300 million. But by his acknowledgement, his post is insincere. I do appreciate the comments, but I realize that this was to prove a point that most people do not want to pay more for taxes. But
is this your Southern gentleman?
It's my best. Oh, it's really South Carolina. Best I can do.
I'm enjoying it.
But are for taxes when the other guy is to be taxed, wrote Sanford in a comment on the campaign page. Sanford created the campaign on August the 6th. As of this writing, it has received almost $600 towards its $300 million goal. Best idea I've had. And then Sanford puts this up. The Alabama state government is currently in the midst of a budget fight, nearing the end of a special sessions to resolve a shortfall in funding. An Alabama state Senate bill proposed cuts to Medicaid and some other state agencies, but the state house rejected it on Monday night. Balancing priorities and proposed cuts has made its made this summer is an especially heated one in Montgomery. One point of contention has emerged from the legislators' apparent unwillingness to raise taxes and Governor Bailey's demand for $300 million in revenue.
So the $300 million is the shortfall, right?
That's the revenue.
Oh, okay. Because I see the headline here from News5WKRG.com, GoFundMe account for Alabama budget shortfall.
That's the shortfall. I don't know. Guess that makes sense.
It makes more sense to me that would be the shortfall because...
I don't know what these organizations spend. I mean, $300 million doesn't sound like much, but I'm not an expert in this stuff.
Well, no. I mean, I'm pretty sure the New Hampshire government spends over $1 billion in this state.
I'll take your word for it.
I haven't run the numbers myself, but I'm pretty sure I've seen that's the case. The Senator Sanford wrote in the description of his GoFundMe page, quote, "The state of Alabama is experiencing tight financial times and needs your help. Legislators are debating possible financial solutions, but are finding that raising taxes are not wanted by the citizens of Alabama. Rather than have the government come after your hard-earned money, now you can send an amount that fits your budget, even request where your money be used. You can determine what functions of government are a priority to you." And you're saying he's not serious about that this is all just a joke?
I can't figure out what the guy's trying to get across in this, but I think it does show that, you know, in certain circumstances, people just aren't willing to pay. I think people aren't going to pay as long as they've been getting services for free. Right?
No doubt.
So at some point or another, these services...
But they haven't been getting services for free.
Right, well, they've been paying just through taxes.
They have, but really what they can do in many cases is get the other guy to pay. If 80% of people want to get 20% of people to pay, then... You know, they have all different funding mechanisms where rich people, have to bear the brunt of the payment. And that's all fine and dandy. But I think it comes down to at some point or another that these are services and you should pay for the services, the quantity of services you get.
So I think that if this were actually happening in a voluntary society, I'd be okay with it. If this were all the Alabama government were doing, if in 2016 the Alabama government decided, okay, we're done with taxes, we're going to the GoFundMe campaign funding method, and that was the only way to actually send money to the state government, that people actually had to do it on a consensual basis, that they really did have to decide in their own mind what the Alabama government state services are worth, and then pony up for it, I think that would be a very interesting experiment. But obviously the government guys aren't going to do that because they love the tax system. It guarantees them income. And if they were to raise their money with a GoFundMe every year, like all kinds of various different organizations do, then there'd be a big question mark about how much money they would get year in and year out. So it'll never happen, at least unless voluntarists manage to take over the Alabama state government, which doesn't seem very likely. But just on its own, if this were the only funding mechanism, that would be a totally voluntarist solution, would it not?
Seems legit to me. I'm trying to imagine, like, what would a mafia don ever say? All right, here's the deal, guys. Now, this year is going to be different. No more shakedowns. We're just going to go ask for the money.
No, of course. The don would never do that.
So
doesn't this show that voluntary solutions don't work?
No, it doesn't show that. This man is not a voluntarist.
Well,
and also, these people don't have their money. This is not a voluntary society where people get to keep what they earn.
They've already had their money stolen from them. This is in addition to by the government.
By the same people asking for more of it.
Well, hold on. So the people who are asking for more of it are proposing to steal more of it, right?
They're going to steal more of it.
This is what they claim they need to operate. And organizations do need money to operate. So, when they put out an amount... Like, they've gotten $600 of the $300 million they've asked for.
So, right, but they also have the $1 billion plus or whatever it is the state budget is.
Okay, whatever. But they're not going to. They're not getting the money. They're not even getting close to the money they're asked for.
Well, there could be a lot of reasons why they're not successful. Maybe they're not marketing themselves well. I mean, this is not an indication that a voluntary society would fail.
They've gotten a bunch of news stories, and so far they've gotten $600.
Well, I've never heard about it until just now. So.
$28 billion, Mark, is the Alabama state budget as of 2014. So you're talking about a small fraction of the total amount that these guys are talking about.
So people
about
are just not
with.
Willing to give more, is your claim?
Well, of course not. Everybody knows that government is incredibly inefficient. Why would somebody want to voluntarily give them more money above and beyond the $29 billion that they already have?
Yes. Government's not going to get more efficient government's not going to get more efficient with less money or more money. The only way government's going to get efficient is if they understand that the money can be cut off.
That's what I'm saying.
And they have to be in competition.
Saying that this is some sort of example of voluntarism is not accurate at all.
I think a lot of people will look at it as exactly that, though.
No,
well,
I would
say...
they
don't understand voluntarism, then.
It's more equivalent to, like, a robber who steals from me on Sunday, coming around on Friday saying, hey, you know, I'm wearing a suit now, and I'm real friendly now. And
I need a little more.
Yeah, so how about just, you know, just another buck, please?
Yeah, exactly. I think that nails it, Derrick J., because you know, this isn't voluntarism. Voluntarism is where every interaction between humans is based on consent. The $29 billion that they already have was not based on consent. They're trying to get – this guy is making a political statement, essentially, and it's just an interesting thing. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Well, maybe a bike lane can be crowdfunded. That's what Derrick J. will be telling us about coming up. But you can join us and share your thoughts here. This is Free Talk Live.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates? Or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education? Or maybe one the U.S. News & World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies. For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
Are you excited about the World Wide Web? Do you want a place where you can share your ideas and express yourself? Well, dial up your modems and stream on down to the GCN Live Community Forum. Lots of radical features await you there.
Wow, Internet guy, I am so glad I went to the GCN Live Community Forum.
You too can discover why the World Wide Web is awesome. Just go to gcnlive.com/forum. That's gcnlive.com/forum. I'll see you in cyberspace. Friend GCN Live on Diaspora and Cross.tv.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here, toll-free, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. With you in the studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Derrick J.
And Mark.
And, of course, you can join us online. Just drop on by freetalklive.com. We've got listening options there. You can tune in live. You can listen to our live streams anytime, actually, because Free Talk Live is there 24/7. We've also got archives. You can click and download MP3 archives. You can subscribe to our podcast. You can even listen on a satellite feed in a good chunk of some of the planet. So you can go and learn more over at freetalklive.com and get tuned in at your leisure in the way that works best for you. Did I mention the over 150 radio stations we've got? Yeah, we've got that too. So we've been discussing the idea of crowdfunding government, and I think that it's a good idea. This state senator in Alabama is not, I don't think he's serious about this. He's just sort of making a political statement because there's this budget impasse or whatever there in Alabama where they're looking to spend $300 million more than they've actually budgeted for. And so this guy made a GoFundMe campaign for that $300 million, and it's raised all of $600-something dollars in pledges thus far. But if that actually were a way for government to raise money, then I think that would be a wonderful replacement for the current system, the status quo as we know it. If government is truly providing a service that is valuable to people, then surely they will voluntarily fund it. Now, maybe each government department needs to have their own crowdfunding campaign. That way each person can kind of put money in.
I would say every project.
Yeah.
Like whatever's being done.
Of course, that makes it more complicated to promote, right? Like if it's all throw the money into one hat kind of thing, then you just promote that one URL. Like if you've got 10 different fundraisers just for Derrick J's different projects, yeah, that could get a little complicated.
Yeah, but Derrick J doesn't do everything that Ian wants, you know? So what if I fix potholes, but then I also go do some activism you don't like? You know, so it's just like, mm-hmm. I want to know what project I'm funding. I don't want to fund some organization and let them do whatever with the money. I think that's part of the beauty of crowdfunding is that you get to choose exactly
which
what you
project.
Want.
Yeah,
and it doesn't have to be a lot. It's not like you have to send $100 everywhere. You could send $10 to this project and $10 to that one. So anyway, that's what they're doing with this new bike path in Denver.
Yeah, tell me about the bike path, because that sounds a little more achievable. I don't know what their goal is for the crowd fund, but I imagine it's not $300 million.
Well, it's been working since 2011. People have been using crowdfunding projects to get government services. So here, well, I'll explain. Headline from Bloomberg Business. Want a bike path? Pay for it yourself. Crowdfunding is one way to get a local project done. But wait a minute, what do you pay taxes for? By Amanda Albright. And this article...
What do you pay them for, indeed?
So you don't go to prison.
That's mostly.
Right. Yeah,
that's all. Your friends ask you to fund their marathon training, their home renovations, even their potato salad. Why not crowdfund something you'd actually use?
That actually happened, right? Like somebody put a potato salad recipe on there or something. And
that's
they...
no joke. There's a link to the potato salad Indiegogo
and
fundraiser.
It worked,
yes.
Like big time.
Oh, way more than expected. Yeah. So why not crowdfund something you'd actually use, such as a bike path or a public park? That's what a growing number of startups are helping people do, as communities with a goal of looking for sources of financing outside the municipal bond market. More and more, this is a quote, more and more people are seeing this as an alternative avenue to going through your tax dollars or local public servant, says Slava Rubin, the chief executive officer of Indiegogo, a crowdfunding platform. Hmm. Rubin says he started seeing public works projects appear on the site in 2011, with campaigns funding small-scale infrastructure projects such as a $1,000 dog park in Chicago, and that he expects interest to increase.
Yeah, I think people want certain services from their government that is just it's easier to do without that. And when you're talking about something new, then that is something I think you can get people on board with. When you're talking about continuing to do something that we've got, people aren't so interested in. Because I'll bet you what they didn't fundraise for was every other year of maintenance for that dog park after that. So, yeah, $1,000 will put up a chain link fence around a given city lot that they managed to have donated or whatever to their. But who's mowing it? Who's going and picking up the dog poo? Who is doing whatever else that there needs to be done for this? And by the way, the city probably, because this is donated and it's being used for everybody, it probably doesn't have to pay taxes, whereas your property does.
Mm-hmm. According to Rubin, remember, he's the chief executive officer at Indiegogo, quote, government is a very slow-moving industry, and it's quite bureaucratic. Indiegogo and anyone who runs a campaign is able to move much more nimbly. The pickup in crowdfunded infrastructure project comes at a time of waning city budgets and interest in funding projects, says Aaron Barnes, a founder of IOBI, a startup that helps neighborhood residents kickstart public works development. Brooklyn-based IOBI has helped individual contributors fund about $2 million in projects, such as bike lanes, gardens, and park landscaping.
I love this. I think it's a great idea. It brings people together. It gets them excited about getting something done. And we've seen that when people move on their own volition, whether it's a neighborhood association that needs to fix some roads when the government won't do it, and they go ahead and they do it anyway without the government's permission, we've seen people move very, very quickly on this, but they also tend to get in trouble. At least those are the stories we've seen. So maybe there are a number of these folks who are managing to pull this off. They can do the fundraising and actually perform the work somehow with the government's blessing, because usually when we hear about somebody going out and filling potholes on their own or making a crosswalk, they get arrested or they're threatened with some sort of criminal charge and sanctions and fines. So I guess I'm wondering how do they successfully interface with the government on this? Is it like they go to the city council and they say, hey, we want to do this fundraising thing? Obviously, you shouldn't ask for permission first.
Well,
do you come to them and say, hey, we just raised, without even talking to the counselors, do you come to the city councilor and say, oh, we just raised $10,000 for painting a new bike lane, or what? I don't know what that costs, $10,000 to paint a new bike lane. Can we go ahead and do this without getting arrested?
I think that's probably, I'm just making a guess, but I think that these are humans, the governments, yeah, they're bureaucratic, but they don't run like machines. Mm-hmm. And they could be swayed by people who pay deference to them. It would be so great if you could be at the ribbon cutting ceremony.
They would love to be at a ribbon cutting.
Oh, great. Okay. And we don't even have to spend any money. Oh, yeah. Oh, this is wonderful. Just throw on some accolades for the great politicians, pat themselves on the back. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, you're so great. Thanks for allowing us to do this.
Ya.
Yeah.
Yeah. We couldn't have done this without getting thrown in jail because you people are crazy.
Yeah, so I imagine that's probably how it's done. This has only been $2 million so far, and this is just in Brooklyn. So I imagine that kind of money can sort of just float by city government, and they probably don't even notice.
Hmm.
If federal and state governments are spending less on public works projects than in recent years, despite historically low interest rates, with transportation and water...
Infrastructure.
Yep. Transportation and water infrastructure spending in the U.S. declining about 10% in the last 10 years... According to a Congressional Budget Office report, Tracy Gordon, a senior fellow at the Urban Institute State and Local Finance Initiative, says public-private partnerships are starting to fill the void. So I guess that's what they're talking about. It sounds like fascism to me when I hear public-private partnerships, but Maybe it's a good thing.
Well, if it gets the park beautified, I think it's a good thing. And we see
fascism
this here,
can work for you.
Well, we see this here in Keene, where there's a Schwelet Park, which is right nearby the Keene studios for LRN.FM. And there are little rocks and things like that in the park that have people's names on them. And there's actually a volunteer squad that goes into the park and they, you know, they pull the weeds and they plant new plants every springtime. And there's actually a group of people, from what I understand, that is very, very dedicated to this particular plot of public land that is interested in taking care of it. And that's why the park is so beautiful, I think, because of the efforts of the volunteers who are augmenting it. And this takes that to another level, although I imagine those same volunteers are also doing their own fundraising to get the plants, to buy, to, you know, to purchase the plants and things like that. This would be a different way for them to perhaps do it, because maybe they're doing it the old school method of just calling a few known contributors. But if they actually put it out there as a crowdfunding campaign, it may actually blossom into even more funding than they could have imagined. I think it's an interesting approach.
Well, according to this expert, she says, what I hear is that debt is a four-letter word. There's a strong anti-debt, anti-tax sentiment out there. Politicians are very concerned that voters won't approve a municipality selling bonds to fund a project. When municipalities do sell or refinance bonds, it's more likely to pay for large-scale projects
like
with a lot
school.
Of community visibility, such as a school or a stadium. And crowdsourcing allows communities to target projects with smaller price tags that might otherwise get overlooked.
And without having to wait and wait until you finally get permission, you can just go out and fundraise and then figure out how to spend it. There's more. You can join us for it. 855-450-FREE. Coming up, 250 prosecutors disqualified in Orange County, California. We'll tell you why. Free Talk Live.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
Geico applauds your inner road name.
A slow clap goes out to your biker alter ego. You might be mild-mannered Michael in the office, the guy known for raising his hand in meetings, but out on the open road, it's Motor Mike. Geico supports you and your bike, Motor Mike, because beyond cars, Geico insures motorcycles, those glorious vroom vroom machines. With 24/7 customer service and great rates, the only thing you'll be raising from now on is a heck of a good time. Woo! So head out on the highway and make that road yours, Mike. Make it yours.
Geico Motorcycle. See how much you could save.
This is your Robertson Roberts Brokerage Daily Precious Metals Update. In early trading Monday, gold is $7 higher at $1,121 per ounce. Silver is up 10 cents at $15.40 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $256. Robertson Roberts has been helping people with buying and selling precious metals for nearly 40 years. If you would like more information, give us a call, 800-874-9760, or visit our website at rrbi.co.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, August 17th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.31 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,119 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $259. Antiwar.com reports, while Iraqi officials continue to downplay the difficulty of turning the tables on the Islamic State, which has captured much of the country's western border with Syria, the government's primary efforts seem to be passing around blame for the major defeats of the war so far. Iraqi Prime Minister Haider Abadi has been loudly critical of the military for the loss of the Anbar capital of Ramadi, saying the troops fled despite orders to stay and defeat the Islamic State. On Sunday, he ordered the commanders court-martialed for abandoning their defensive positions and losing the city. They're not alone in facing blame, however, as the Iraqi parliament has issued a report blaming a number of former government officials, including former Prime Minister Nouri al-Maliki, for the loss of Mosul, the largest city to fall to the Islamic State. In both cases, the underlying assumption is that the battles could have been won if the troops had simply followed the orders to win those battles, and Maliki is facing blame for installing commanders who weren't willing to win the Battle of Mosul. Though it was a surprise how quickly the military lines broke in Mosul, the loss of Ramadi shouldn't have been nearly so surprising, as the poor morale among Iraqi forces was already well documented, and it was clear they simply weren't going to stand up to a sustained the Islamic State offensive. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports at least one person has died so far and many homes have been burned to the ground as four wildfires spread in the western United States. The blazes, burning in drought-ravaged California, Oregon, Washington, and Idaho, have wrought havoc on miles of acreage in recent days. The largest, the so-called Soda Fire, has so far burned nearly 300,000 acres, and the state's Lawyer Complex Fire has so far destroyed more than 50 homes, according to officials. A woman died Friday as she was preparing to flee the wildfire, according to officials, and authorities believe she fell and injured her head. Idaho's governor declared a state of emergency in part of that state. In California, the Cabin Fire, which was sparked Saturday, is approaching 2,000 acres and is 20% contained. In Oregon, 35,000 acres of land have been torched by the lightning-caused Canyon Creek Complex Fire, and more than 100 structures have been destroyed in Washington State. Weather conditions affected by the fires vary across each of the states, and officials said air quality is at its worst levels in some places.
Are you an advocate for free market money? Do you promote Bitcoin as an alternative in a fiat-centric world? Then you need Spendabit in your arsenal, the search engine for things you can buy with Bitcoin. Spendabit aggregates millions of products from thousands of Bitcoin-enabled merchants. Keep your money in the free economy. Visit spendabit.co today. Bitcoin merchants, ask about our merchant suite to reach even more customers. Spendabit.co.
Reuters reports Greece's socialist PASOK party joined the main opposition on Sunday in saying it would not back Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras if he calls a confidence vote following a rebellion in the governing party over a new bailout deal. Tsipras had to rely on opposition groups, including PASOK, to win a parliamentary majority on Friday in favor of the 86 billion euro bailout program, Greece's third with international creditors since 2010. By contrast, Tsipras suffered the biggest rebellion yet among anti-bailout lawmakers from his leftist Syriza party, forcing him to consider a confidence vote that would pave the way for early elections if he loses. Opinion polls show Tsipras remains popular even though he presided over the closure of banks for 3 weeks, the imposition of capital controls, and a near brush with financial collapse. This has raised doubts about how much the opposition parties may want to force new elections. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Tomorrow's my big day. I'm going to go in for surgery, and hopefully you'll come along. Now, I do have to admit that I am in a bit of pain, so I'm really looking forward to this procedure. I think we're both going to find out that having surgery just isn't as scary as it sounds.
we're covering our own Jim Haggerty's kidney stone removal surgery, and his surgery is now just minutes away. So, Dr. Atkin, tell us what precautions we would take to prevent us from getting kidney stones.
Always stay hydrated. Water helps the kidneys break the stuff down.
Hear that, Jim? More water.
What?
More water. Maybe we should replace your coffee.
Please go away.
That's a camera they're going to use to film the whole surgery from inside Jim's body,
yes, that's
going to
be pushed into Jim's urethra as well. Normally they wouldn't do this. This is purely for the benefit of us watching it on TV.
All right, stick with us, because first he's going to pop into the children's ward to cheer up some youngsters suffering from terminal illnesses.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here on the toll-free lines, 855-450-FREE. With you in the studio tonight, it's Ian,
Derrick J,
and Mark.
855-450-FREE. Join us via Skype. Skype usernames lrn.fm. You know, every now and then, a judge makes an interesting decision, one that might actually be worth supporting. In this case, it's a judge in Orange County, California. Stories from Daily Kos, or Daily Kos, I'm not sure how you pronounce that, dailykos.com. Between San Diego and Los Angeles is Orange County, California, with more than 3 million residents. It's larger than 21 states. If Orange County were a separate country, its economy would be the 45th largest in the world. Now known for Disneyland,
it's pretty big.
Yeah, the county may soon be known for having one of the most corrupt justice systems in the world. The width and depth and duration of the corruption truly boggles the mind. A case that should have been open and shut has blown the lid off of some deep secrets. On October 12, 2011, Orange County experienced the deadliest mass killing in its modern history. Scott DeCray killed 8 people, including his ex-wife, in a Seal Beach beauty salon. He was arrested wearing full-body armor just a few blocks away. Without a doubt, DeCray was the perpetrator. A dozen surviving witnesses saw him do it. He admitted to the shooting early on. Yet nearly 4 years later, the case against him has all but fallen apart. It turns out that prosecutors and police officers committed an egregious violation of Mr. DeCray's rights. So much so that Superior Court Judge Thomas Goethals shocked everyone and removed the Orange County District Attorney's Office and all 250 of their prosecutors from having anything more to do with the case. The legal wrangling involved how DeCray came to occupy a jail cell next to a prolific jailhouse informant. Prosecutors and jailers said it was a coincidence, but DeCray's attorney insisted it was part of a widespread operation to elicit incriminating remarks from defendants who are represented by lawyers, a violation of their rights. Mm. This is actually an old trick, from what I understand.
Yeah.
You know, you put a guy in jail, and then you put a confederate in, some cop whose job is to ferret out information, or maybe
usually
just an informant.
Not a cop; it's just somebody who's trying to work off a sentence or something like that. Very few police officers are willing to spend a great deal of time in jail and expose themselves. A lot of these informants are in general population in a cell block. So no, I would disagree that it's a cop. Generally.
Yeah, that's a good point. It's one of their people, though, somebody who's working for the police. A narc, if you will.
You can characterize it how you wish, I'm just saying.
And the idea would be that, well, you're in jail, so you're not expecting some cop to be talking to you while you're in there, and somebody comes up to you and says, hey, what are you in for? And so begins a conversation where maybe that person will admit to doing some of the things that they otherwise wouldn't admit to in court, maybe.
But could that be used? I mean, wouldn't that be hearsay? Maybe they're talking up a good game so they don't get beat up in jail.
They could be doing that. You're right about that. It's something that they've been known to do in the past.
It's not hearsay if you heard it. So if, you know, if for whatever reason Ian tells me something, I can testify that he told me that.
Yeah, but there's hearsay. No guarantee that a person is being honest 100% of the time.
That's the jury's job.
Yeah, but you don't take an oath when you enter jail that you'll always be honest.
Look, I mean, neither does a civilian. I mean, but a civilian can testify that, you know, that Ian told them something before he was put in jail. So an inmate can testify that he told him something after he was put in jail. The difficulty is that, you know, obviously convict testimonies are suspect. People understand that, you know, the convicts are willing to say just about anything to get out of whatever it is that they're being sentenced for.
Yeah.
So they have to be convincing.
I think juries should look at convict testimony the opposite of how they look at, like, mother testimony or whatever. Or maybe in the same way, you know, like, oh, my son is great. He would never do a crime. He's totally innocent. You know, if the convict is saying, you know, selling this guy down the river, oh, he totally did it. Yeah. He told me all about his secrets. You just don't trust him. You can't believe these guys.
District Attorney Tony Rakukas, this conflict of interest in the DeRay case is not imaginary, the judge wrote. It apparently stems from his loyalty to his law enforcement partners at the expense of his other constitutional and statutory obligations. It turns out that Orange County has a secret system of evidence manufacturing and storage that they've used in countless cases, and the collusion is unraveling dozens of cases and may soon unravel the careers of countless prosecutors and law enforcement officers who've maintained this secret for decades.
How does this judge know that 250 of these prosecutors were keeping this secret?
How did the cat get
out of the bag?
All he's done in this case is really has banned them from having anything more to do with this particular case. It's not that they've all been disqualified forever, unfortunately. The headline isn't quite what the story reveals. But let's talk about TREAD. What does it stand for? Actually, I don't know yet. In recent months, we've learned over the objections of the Orange County Sheriff's Department that the agency created TREAD, which is a computerized record system in which deputies store information about in-custody defendants, including informants. Some of the data is trivial. Others contain vital exculpatory evidence. But for a quarter of a century, the OCSD, the Sheriff's Department, deemed TREAD beyond the reach of any outside authority. In the DeCray case, deputies Ben Garcia and Seth Tunstall committed perjury to hide the mere existence of this computerized record system, TREAD. Those lies didn't originate from blind loyalty, however. The concealed records show how prosecution teams slyly trampled the constitutional rights of defendants by employing informants and then keeping clueless judges, juries, and defense lawyers. These violations are beginning to cause cases all over the country to crumble. Other cases involve informants who are eliciting illegal confessions. Those have emerged. Entire cases have collapsed, and more may follow. The story goes way back to the 1980s, as R. Scott Moxley explains at length in the Orange County Weekly, to a prosecutorial scandal that ended in the execution of one defendant and a lengthy sentence for his alleged co-conspirator. Their convictions were based on the testimony of various jailhouse informants, even though they had told conflicting stories. The scandal rocked the area then, and this new one shows eerie parallels. Leonel Vega, a notorious gang member, was convicted of murdering a 17-year-old and was due to get life without possibility of parole. He may now be released in 2019 because of violations of his rights. So what you have happening here is these prosecutors are using methods that are not legal to get convictions.
And the result is, apparently, inmates are being, you know, scary people are being let out.
Right. Getting people let out, or perhaps even getting off of charges entirely because they are bungling these cases. Another case, one of the most egregious murders in the history of the county, has been bungled. Jeanette Espoleta, 8 months pregnant, was kidnapped and murdered. But the DA's office there has done the unthinkable. Similar to the DeCray case, government actors took the easily solvable Espoleta murder and unnecessarily cheated. In some ways, the case is worse than the lingering aforementioned death penalty trial that garnered national attention. During the past 17 years, prosecution teams hid exculpatory evidence, secured tainted testimony, won convictions, and then duped state appellate court justices into believing they never swerved from their sworn oaths. It's an alarming situation that's not based on speculation. While most prosecutors and cops that I see in court are honest, some even significantly underpaid for their work, the record alone in the Espoleta case proves Orange County's criminal justice system needs a cleansing. Now, when you're hiding exculpatory evidence, that's one of the most egregious offenses you can possibly commit. Exculpatory evidence is the evidence that will essentially result in someone being found innocent.
This is an evil thing to do.
Yeah. This is the stuff that you're supposed to have access to as a defense attorney and a defendant in a case, any kind of exculpatory evidence. But here, they are hiding it. And
they're not the first agency to do that either.
No, they're just the one that's getting called on it.
And when they get found out, you know, when they get found out, these agencies, oftentimes they just don't do anything to them. In this case, the judge said that these prosecutors can't work on this case anymore. I mean, if they're finding this information out, these people should be going to prison.
No
the
doubt.
Very prison that they're sending people to that they had all exculpatory evidence on.
The public defender's office filed a 500-plus page motion detailing instance after instance of cases like this where people have had their rights violated. You can share your thoughts with us on Free Talk Live. More coming up.
This is a life-changing message for anyone with sleep apnea who is on the go and tired of dragging around a big, bulky home CPAP device. MiniCPAP.com now offers a portable device that's as small as a soda can and weighs less than a pound. For even more freedom, you can add a battery that's as tiny as a deck of cards. It's called the Transcend Mini CPAP, and right now you can try it risk-free for 21 days by calling 1-800-939-8536. Transcend is the world's first portable mini CPAP device. It gives you the freedom to sleep in total comfort anywhere you are. Our smallest and most advanced portable design ever, Transcend, is so small and so light you can fit it in your briefcase or purse to use anywhere you go. It's FAA compliant too, so you can even sleep comfortably while flying. Enjoy the freedom to sleep comfortably anywhere. Call MiniCPAP.com now for your 21-day in-home trial. 1-800-939-8536. That's 1-800-939-8536.
Mike Stenerson for Midas Resources. At no time in history have precious metals been more important, certainly not in my 22 years in the industry. The dollar has lost over 90% of its value in the last 60 years. No fiat currency has ever survived the government printing presses. Ours is not immune. The time is now to be proactive. 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Anything tied to the dollar is at risk. CDs, annuities, 401ks, IRAs, stocks, bonds, you name it, so decide. Do you want to leave a legacy of wealth or debt for your family? The choice is yours. Call me at 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. That's 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Be proactive, not reactive. Call 1-800-686-2237, extension 116.
Our digital freedom is under attack. Look no further than Ross Ulbricht's life sentence to see that. After all, it's not Ross's freedom they're after. It's yours.
It is bigger than Ross and bigger than a website. I think one website is by far less dangerous than the government trampling on our rule of law.
The appeal is underway, and we've organized a grassroots fundraiser at thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Up for grabs is Cody Wilson's Ghost Gunner, A Week in Costa Rica, My Magic Mud, Ghost Outside the Machine t-shirt.
These prizes are really great. There's a ton more, so go to thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. Please tell all your friends, share it up.
Our grassroots tactics allow for 100% of all funds raised to go directly to freeross.org. So check out thecryptoshow.com/freeRoss. And don't forget freeross.org.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market.
The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross has been sentenced to life in prison with no possibility of parole. Now, an appeal is Ross's only chance, and he needs your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
We are scratching what is likely the tip of the iceberg, the tip of the corruption iceberg in one county, just one county. And we're talking about Orange County in California, where there have been some amazing revelations as of late within the last few months. At least that's when it's hit the news as of Daily Kos. I'm sure this is actually, they've said this has been going on since the 1980s. Some sort of a computerized record system called TRED has all manner of information about in-custody defendants in it, including exculpatory evidence and other vital pieces of information that has been basically off the books. It has been a secretive kind of database. There are now 250 prosecutors in Orange County that have been taken off of one particular case, that none of them are allowed to work on a case that has basically been ruined by the prosecution and them holding back certain
I can't believe
evidence.
They have that many prosecutors. 250 prosecutors? This is the
3 million residents in the county.
I'm just surprised. I'm stunned that there's that many prosecutors in the county.
So we're going on with some more of this story from Daily Kos, but I also want to let you know how to get gold and silver, because these are great alternative currencies, whether you're looking at them for an investment purpose or you are just wanting to have something that you can use in a pinch instead of the U.S. government's currency. Silver and gold can help you with that. And you can go to silver.freetalklive.com. The folks over at Midas Resources, they've been doing this for a long time, supplying folks with gold and silver in very fancy packaging, as far as, like, you know, they have these, what do they call them, numismatics. They're not just a gold bullion.
Yeah.
There's pretty
They're
things
old coins.
On them.
Yeah.
Yeah, some of them are older than others.
Well, bullion is the decorative stuff. Mm-hmm. Numismatics is the old stuff.
Okay, I thought a numismatic was just something that had a date on it.
It's collectible.
Got it. Bullion isn't
bullion
dated?
Can have a
bullion
date.
Bullion can have dates,
okay,
but it might be from this year.
Okay, but it's just...
That wouldn't make it special.
It's not collectible because there's so much of it or something like that?
It's not yet collectible.
Got it.
Give it a couple of centuries, it'll be fine.
So anyway, go to silver.freetalklive.com or gold.freetalklive.com. The Public Defender's Office has filed a 500-plus page motion, actually linked to it here for those of you who really want to go and read every instance, according to them, of cases where men and women in Orange County have had their essential rights violated. Laura Fernandez of the Yale Law School, who studies prosecutorial misconduct, says it's amazing that both the sheriff's office and the DA's office worked together to cover up this misconduct. Well, my goodness, how could this be that the prosecution and the sheriffs would work together to, you know, be corrupt together? What a shock.
Who else would work together?
I wonder what sort of openness there is about it in their own personal lives. I mean, do they only talk in metaphors with each other about how they're colluding behind the scenes? Do they just go right out to lunch together and talk about what their plans are?
Yeah, like, hey, Johnny, did you hide away the files for the Smith case today?
Yeah, yeah. There's some evidence in that case that could really ruin our side of it. We probably should hide that.
When you get back to the office, make sure you grab the paper shredder and get started. Yeah,
yeah, are they
open?
Totally clear about what they want, or is it all just suggestion?
Good question. From my perspective, says the law school speaker here, what really sets Orange County apart is the massive cover-up by both law enforcement and prosecutors, a cover-up that appears to have risen to the level of perjury and obstruction of justice.
Yeah, it appears to.
Law enforcement officers and prosecutors in Orange County have gone to such lengths
to conceal their wide-ranging misconduct, that they have effectively turned the criminal justice system on its head, dismissing charges and reducing sentences in extraordinarily serious cases, utterly failing to investigate unsolved crimes and many murders by informants in order to prevent that evidence from ever getting to defense lawyers, while simultaneously pushing forward where it would seem to make no sense, except that it conceals more bad acts by the state, as in the case of an innocent 14-year-old boy who was wrongfully detained for 2 years.
Oh, God. 2 years for somebody who's innocent.
And now Al Jazeera has launched a full investigation as it uncovered never-before-heard audio files of conversations between illegal informants. Excerpt from Al Jazeera, the U.S. government is prohibited from using informants to gather information on defendants who have retained counsel. Doing so violates their right to remain silent and their right to an attorney. But in court filings, Sanders claims the jailhouse informants in Orange County were acting as government agents and taking direction from law enforcement. So just wholesale violations of people's rights. Faced with a possible life sentence, Oscar Morial, a jailhouse informant, spoke to Orange County law enforcement about how his memory, quote, might be able to fall back into place, unquote, if they could help him out somehow. And now prosecutors in Orange County are unethically steering cases away from this very same judge who kicked them off the case in the Seal Beach murders and has been persistent about their violations.
This is one of the
cases.
Problems is the prosecutors have an incredible amount of power inside of this system, and they can steer cases away from judges. And these are judges that are trying to simply hold them responsible for their actions in some cases. We've seen this elsewhere. This system isn't fair. And it hasn't been for a long time, people.
The toll-free number here for you to join us and share your thoughts, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Now the dean of the law school at UC Irvine is calling for a federal probe into the misconduct if prosecutors and law enforcement officers in Orange County are so willing to lie, cheat, and break the law in the name of justice in the ways that we've discovered. What else have they been willing to do? Who might have been wrongfully convicted? Who else has had their rights trampled, no matter the seriousness of their crimes? How deep will this rabbit hole go? And who will fight against the truth coming out to protect their careers? And there's another question that they didn't ask, and that is that this is just Orange County. What makes anyone out there think that any other county is any less corrupt than this one? Why would Cheshire County, New Hampshire, be any different?
Even if 50% is corrupt, you're still talking about extraordinarily corrupt.
So you really have to ask yourself, is Orange County the only place where this kind of thing is going on? Of course not. This isn't where the cops learned how to do this or the prosecutors learned how to do this. Not every cop in Orange County has worked in Orange County their entire lives. So there are likely things like this going on in all manner of different police jurisdictions. It's just that they've been covering up effectively in Orange County for decades. So you can better believe they're doing their
apparently
due diligence
they can,
in other counties.
They can cover up effectively. And if they can cover up effectively, then other places can cover up effectively.
Right.
Just because there hasn't been a news story on your county doesn't mean your county is not as corrupt, or at least somewhat as corrupt, or perhaps even more corrupt than Orange County.
Well, now that all of these Orange County cases have been put into question, I look forward to the announcement by the prosecutors and the judges that they're going to let all those people that they put in jail go, because clearly... You know, this was not respectable. These prosecutors are put into question about their authenticity. They're liars. They gamed the system. So there are going to be consequences, right?
Sure would be nice. I wouldn't get my hopes up on that. If we even see one person fired, I'd be shocked.
No, yeah, I'm not talking.
Me too.
Not about firing them. Let the people go who they put in jail. Now that we know they've been covering up evidence that lets these people be, that would have let them be free?
I would love to see that happen. You can share your thoughts with us here at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Maybe you've got a corruption story that you want to tell about where you live, because there's no shortage of this stuff. It's Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE.
Okay, open your mouth and say ah.
Getting a good view of a sore throat can be difficult, but the new doctor-recommended sore throat exam kit from SayAhNow.com makes it easy. A first-of-its-kind, scientifically designed oral retractor to relax the tongue, minimize gag reflex, and increase visibility. Our made-in-the-USA kit also includes a medical-grade reference chart, easy-to-use website and app so that you're one click away from unparalleled sore throat information. Click SayAhNow.com. SayAhNow.com, a must-have for your family's medical preparedness.
My name is Dell, and I live in El Cajon, California. I was concerned about my cholesterol readings because I knew that high cholesterol is related to clogging of the arteries and increases the risk for heart attack and stroke. One day, I heard an ad for Heart and Body Extract, and I was skeptical, but I decided to give it a try. Man, the numbers don't lie.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
Millions of Americans are irrationally feared dead following a train derailment near Wilmington, Delaware.
Less than 200 people were aboard the train, but because no names have been released yet, countless more are being imagined trapped inside the wreckage by worried parents and overly anxious friends.
And the list of imagined victims is growing by the minute. From brothers-in-law who live in Delaware, who usually drive but could possibly have been on that train, to friends who went to Delaware on a business trip and may have been next to the tracks for some reason when the train derailed.
And sadly, we're getting reports that even those who have never been to Delaware are now also among those irrationally thought killed.
Oh, and we are just now getting word from Homeland Security that they're now warning people their fears may spiral into a wholly new fear that their loved ones never existed at all and are just byproducts of a drug-induced lucid dream in which their consciousness is currently imprisoned.
Such a shame, since this is reality.
There is nothing beyond this to believe otherwise. It would be folly.
This is the Onion News Network.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official listening apps for Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just visit apps.lrn.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Please download, rate it 5 stars, then share the link on social media, and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free, at apps.lrn.fm. That's apps.lrn.fm.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 85% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. If you're a regular reader of FreeKeene.com, you know there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at FreeKeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at FreeKeene.com. That's FreeKeene.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live, you're invited to join us here on the radio waves. Bring up whatever's on your mind. Doesn't have to be naughty prosecutors and police covering up evidence that could set people free because they didn't do it. They got sent to prison, but they didn't do it. It happened a lot in Orange County. You can share your thoughts with us here at 855-450-FREE. And also, we've got Skype on in here at username lrn.fm. With you in the studio tonight, Ian here.
Derrick J.
And Mark.
And Mark, tell me about something fresh.
Yeah, well, you know, we've got a new advertiser here, and I just want to tell everybody about RootWork. So if you've got a business of your own, you know that IT work can be frustrating.
Oh, yeah.
Unreliable, unpredictable, and late. Is this so, Ian?
Uh-huh. I've been through that, and I even know a thing or two about IT.
It doesn't have to be. IT can serve your needs reliably, predictably, and on time. RootWork Infotech helps businesses achieve always-on reliability, keeping your customers happy and your staff productive. RootWork can make IT meet your needs. And to prove it, they'll give you 30 minutes on the phone with a senior consultant for free to answer any of your IT questions.
Wow.
And yeah, I mean, this is it's a great way to start. You're going to get something out of this telephone call already. And remember, this is for people who, you know, they need their IT to work. And this is an extraordinarily valuable portion of your business. So just go to get your free consultation, rootwork.it/FTL, and you can get your free call. It's R-O-O-T, rootwork.it/FTL. That's FTL as in Free Talk Live.
Let's go to Tom. He's in Baltimore. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Derrick, Jay, and Mark. Hello, Tom.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Welcome.
You wondered aloud what type of collusion occurs outwardly between prosecutors and police officers and others within the judicial system. I say that in quotes. I worked as a law enforcement officer for many years. Mm-hmm. And I can tell you, I came across a few decent prosecutors. For the most part, though, they all adhere, most of them adhere to the system, which is described, and admittedly so, as an adversarial system. I'll give you one example of many that I experienced. It took me a while to catch on to this. In fact, I was surprised the other night. I was watching a popular cable talk show, and they had a panel of lawyers who were amazed at some of the allegations coming out of the Mosby. She's the prosecutor in Baltimore with the six police officers, mm-hmm. who was accused of hiding some evidence from the defense team. And they just couldn't believe that this prosecutor was looking for a conviction as opposed to the truth. And, you know, I guess they were sincere in what they were saying, but I'll tell you, for experienced attorneys, I was shocked. Maybe it's different in other states, but I know for a fact in Baltimore, they're not looking for the truth. They're looking for convictions. That's what they drive for. And again, I'll give you one quick example. A young man, I think he was probably 19, a kid for all intents and purposes, was convicted of possession of a deadly weapon and given a pretty harsh sentence by the judge. And I was in the courtroom, and I realized I was really good in law. I just had a knack for little nuances. And I realized that what he was convicted of actually was not, by Maryland law, considered a deadly weapon. And so I jumped up and ran over to the prosecutor and said, there's been a mistake. Yeah. And she said, well, what do you mean? So I told her real quick, and she looked at me just in shock. And she said, whose side are you on anyway?
Wow.
Yeah.
The truth, lady?
Yeah, but she doesn't have a side. People are just going to prison after they're done with her. I mean, like, she's on the side of terrible convictions? Injustice?
Yeah, she wants her numbers up, right? As a prosecutor, mm-hmm. what's her incentive to get
I don't even get
lock-ups?
That much, though. I mean, really? A prosecutor somehow gets...
Yes, that's their reward. That's their keeping
that's
score.
That's how they parlay into political careers, too, right? Like, I was the toughest prosecutor Orange County has ever seen, and here's my conviction record.
But if you had 10% fewer convictions as a prosecutor than you do, is that somehow going to lose you the election and for the judgeship that you're running for?
You don't get a bigger paycheck for finding the truth.
I think it's interesting, Tom, that you were looking for the truth. You came up there with information that could have helped this guy out in that situation, and this lady, she was probably incensed that you, the lowly law enforcement officer, would even dare bring that to her attention. What do you think?
You haven't heard the best of it yet. I was shocked. I told her, I said, whose side am I on? At the risk of sounding like something from a comic book. You know, I thought, you know, we were on the side of truth and justice, you know, the American way. I said, you know what, forget about it. I told the judge, I said, you know, stop this court hearing. You know, there's been justice. And he was, he didn't know what to do. He was flabbergasted. Well, what are you talking about? So I'll tell you in a minute. So I ran and got the guy and his public defender. And I said to the public defender exactly what I told the prosecutor. She didn't want to hear it. So I turned to the young man. I said, listen, forget about this public defender. She's not defending you at all. Nobody apparently is. But here's what's going on. The guy says to me, you know what? I'm not worried about it. I can handle jail. And I said, young man, you have no idea what it is that you're saying here. I'm telling you that you've been wrongly convicted. He said he didn't care.
Wow.
You know, that's the mindset with a lot of these young.
He's institutionalized.
Yeah.
He you know, he's going to get three hots in a cot.
Talk about being resigned to the system.
Yeah, that's frustrating. Hey, it really is. How long did your job last after that? I mean, you're making an outburst in court, talking to telling a judge to stop the case. You're having words with the prosecutor and the defense attorney. How long did you stay employed in that county?
My career lasted until I retired.
Wow.
It didn't have its. It wasn't always as easy as it would have been if I would have kept my mouth shut.
I bet.
I sued the city several times. The old saying, you can't sue City Hall. If you sue in a federal court, you can actually win. I did. I had several instances where I had prosecutors, especially one that comes to mind is not an assistant, but the elected, the top one, actually wanted me and put a lot of pressure on me to drop a case against a friend of hers. I wouldn't do it. It was a minor case, but I felt like, you know what? No one would drop it for me. No one would drop it for your average Joe citizen. I'm not going to drop it because she's a friend of yours. Hmm. And I didn't, and I caught a lot of hell for it. But, you know, there was nothing that they could do with getting me to drop the charges. However, oddly enough, the case just kind of disappeared eventually. It was postponed several times. And then I never heard anything about it. When I saved all the paperwork, when I researched it, it just never comes up in the system. And that's pretty common when it comes to public officials. I have no problem with arresting elected officials or people high in government. I did several times, and it always brought me a lot of grief. But it was welcome grief. It was welcome grief that I, to this day, I feel proud that I went ahead and did what I would have done with anybody else.
Well, hey, you know, I appreciate you. Go ahead.
Yeah, Tom, were you called in to speak against the defendant that day that you were in court, or were you just in court for other reasons?
Totally unrelated. I was there for a totally different case.
Oh, okay.
And like I said, that was just one example of many that I came across.
Good for you, Tom. I appreciate it. You'll have to call in with more of your stories another time, but I appreciate hearing from you tonight. Those were some really interesting stories, and I appreciate hearing from you. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Gosh, you know, if you had more people with integrity like that who are willing to actually stand up and point out a wrong when they see it happening, speak up at the moment in time.
The system may not be completely broken.
Well, yeah. I mean, it's broken enough. But
I think good people tend not to be attracted to jobs like this. So it sounds like Tom had kind of a tough time with it.
Well, right. And that's why I'm surprised he was actually able to make it to retirement. I would think that, you know, the entire system would turn against him. There are certainly places where it would. And he would be probably fearing for his life, which is probably why more people don't speak up. It's Free Talk Live. We're coming up.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
By now, you know the smart way to buy emergency food storage is calories per dollar. Ready Supply Foods sells you 50% more food for your money. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. You need 2,000 calories per day under ideal conditions. Most 30-day kits don't have enough calories to sustain you for more than a week. They just don't have enough nutrition to do the job. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We are the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. So you've signed the Shire Society Declaration and are planning your move to New Hampshire to be around more liberty-oriented people. Next, sign up for the Shire Society Forum at forum.shiresociety.com. There are a bunch of people there who are already in the Shire, and they want to meet you. If you're already in the Shire physically, you should also come by the forums. Remember, not everyone uses Facebook. New people are signing up for the Shire Society Forum every month, so drop in and say hello at forum.shiresociety.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733, and join us online at freetalklive.com. We've got Skype as well. You can Skype in here at username lrn.fm. We're talking about the corruption that is just spread far and wide. Probably it strikes even deeper than you could imagine. There are people who are supposed experts that are shocked at the Orange County corruption that has been revealed in recent months there. We talked about that earlier this hour. Shocking, they find it, that there's this level of corruption, collusion between prosecution and the police to hide things like, oh, I don't know, exculpatory evidence that would prove that the person who's the defendant is, in point of fact, not the criminal at all.
That's the definition of exculpatory.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So there's just all kinds of really bad stuff out there, and there's a 500-page motion that has been filed by the Orange County Defense, the Public Defender's Office, just showing people 500 pages worth of it. And there's more than that, I'm sure. But that's just 500 pages for one county.
And all they've done at this point is to take the prosecutors off the case.
One case.
One case.
Yeah.
And
well, they can be trusted with all the others. I mean, they haven't found any evidence that they've done anything wrong with any other cases.
Yeah, they're on the up and up without any other proof that they've been doing bad things. We have to presume they're
I mean, they're honest. You think they've been punished enough, Mark? They've been taken off the case. I mean, what more do you want?
Living a life as a government bureaucrat, I suppose.
Well, it doesn't end there, and it certainly doesn't end in Orange County. BoingBoing.net reporting from a few days ago about a really sad story in Houston. Houston deputy pulled over Charnesia Corley, 21-year-old black woman, on her way to the store to pick up medicine for her sick mother. Thought he smelled weed, the Houston deputy did, in Ms. Corley's car. He searched the car and couldn't find any, then called for a female officer to come to the gas station where Corley was being held so he could have her vagina searched.
Obviously.
That's right. Clearly, if it's not in the car, she must have hidden it up her vagina. They arrested Corley because she objected, can you imagine, to having her vagina examined. In the gas station.
You mean
parking
she
lot.
Said no to that?
Yeah, I mean, how dare she? What is she thinking that she
doesn't
owns
she
herself?
Know he has a badge
from KRTK?
Maybe he didn't announce himself as a cop.
Corley said, "She tells me to pull my pants down." I said, "Ma'am, I don't have any underwear on." And she says, "Well, that doesn't matter. Pull your pants down."
Right on the street.
She admits hesitating. Deputies say she resisted.
Well, wait a minute. Isn't it the cop's job to pull your pants down? It's apparently your job. You have to pull your pants down when ordered.
You have to do it for them, yeah.
I thought they do that. They searched my pockets when I was arrested before. They pat me down. They put their hands in my pockets. Why can't they pull my pants down, too?
Maybe they were under the impression that, like me, they believed that marijuana actually came from vaginas. Like, that's
you got something growing in there, ma'am.
It just comes out. It's like a little dispenser.
Corley told KRTK candidly, "I bend over and she proceeds to try to force her hand inside of me. I tell her, ma'am,
dear me,
no, you cannot do this." She insists at no time did she give consent for any such of a search. She has retained an attorney who argues that a search like this in a public parking lot is a violation of her civil rights.
I'd say that nobody could give consent to this out in public, this is an obscene act.
From the Houston Chronicle, when the female deputy arrived, she told Corley to pull her pants down, but Corley protested because she was cuffed and had no underwear on. According to her attorney, she stood up and protested, so the deputy threw her to the ground and restrained her, while another female was called in to assist. When backup arrived, each deputy held one of Corley's legs apart to conduct the probe.
They had
to. You have to be kidding me.
No, what choice did they have? They had to throw her to the ground while she was handcuffed.
Well, if they didn't force her legs open.
And then take a look inside her marijuana dispenser.
She could have been dangerous. I mean, what if there was a weapon up there?
She could have given that marijuana to children, Derrick J. Well, I mean, that's the real concern here.
We already know she's a criminal. She was resisting.
KRTK TV reports deputies found 0.02 ounces of marijuana on Ms. Corley, but they did not say from where.
Wow.
The Harris
County. Is that like a fifth of a paperclip?
Wow. 0.02
grams.
Oh, no, they said 0.02 ounces.
Ounces. Oh, okay.
It's probably a couple grams or something.
I don't even know if it's that.
Let's see. 28 grams an ounce times 0.02. I can't.
Well, it must have come out of her marijuana dispenser.
It's 0.56, so half a gram. They found half a gram of cannabis, apparently.
You could put roll a pinner out of that.
They found
0.56,
yeah.
Half a gram. They did not say from where. Harris County Sheriff's Office has said their deputies have acted appropriately.
Well, they found some marijuana.
We stand behind our officers. They will do anything that it takes to end this insane war on drugs.
It's insane, all right.
We will lock every single person up after searching all of your body cavities. Now get in line, folks.
Now, I want to be clear
on
this.
Everybody gets a finger in.
I got to get to the bottom of the story. They didn't find any marijuana in the car itself.
That's correct.
They said that. Then they did search her.
Hoo-hoo.
Yep.
And they found some marijuana.
They searched her.
He was right.
And found some marijuana.
But they said it wasn't from the car. So if it wasn't from the car,
it could have been from her pocket.
Could have been in her pocket or her purse.
Oh, okay.
Or something.
All right. Well, I would consider that to be in the car then, I guess.
It could have been on something. I guess there are women's
pockets.
I'd
like to hear more about
small.
This case. Because if this lady actually had marijuana in her marijuana dispenser, I mean, it would be.
Yeah, that guy's
amazing,
good.
Amazing, right?
Yeah. That guy's like, I know you've got it.
I mean,
I'm gonna find
this.
It
is clearly planted, is what it would be, as if they found marijuana up there.
Yeah, it's certainly possible that they planted something later on. You never can trust these police. There's a more detailed story over at The Guardian. By the way, Ms. Corley, who's 21, has no criminal record. So, you know, they had no real reason to believe that she was a drug transporter or anything like that.
Apparently, they had every reason if they found marijuana.
Where was this again? Texas?
Houston, Texas.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
She will be filing a complaint with the Internal Affairs Division, says her attorney. And apparently, they're hoping there's video of the incident, so they don't yet know that. Apparently, she was pulled over for running a stop sign. The officer placed her in the back of his patrol car and searched her vehicle in vain for the drug. This story goes on and just kind of retells it. But if we do hear more about this, we'll certainly let you know. The Harris County Sheriff's Department did not respond to a request for comment as of Tuesday, but a spokesperson did tell local media the deputies did everything as they should and that Corley had assented to a strip search. Really? I mean, does
sure,
anybody
that's
believe
fine.
That?
Yeah, that's okay. You can do that.
Stick oh, I would right love there. To take my clothes off here on the side of the road because that's, you know, everybody's into that.
Well, she may have consented to a search, but not to this search.
They're claiming she consented to a strip search. How many people?
She said we
that?
Could, boss. Yeah. She said we could.
CanMac disputed that and said that an officer's report of the incident, which she had obtained, corroborated his client's version. The attorney declined to say where the marijuana was found, but said police claimed to have found it on her person. Police usually chose not to prosecute for such tiny amounts of marijuana, he added. Regardless of what was found, the search violated privacy and the Constitution. He said, quote, they could have found a kilo of cocaine inside of her and still should not have done it. Rebecca Robertson, legal and policy director of the ACLU of Texas, said a cavity search without a warrant was a blatant violation of the Fourth Amendment and that an orifice probe was the most invasive search possible. She told the Houston Chronicle that a body cavity search without a warrant could be constitutionally suspect, but a body cavity search on the side of the road, I can't imagine a circumstance where that would be constitutional. She noted previous controversies over cavity searches in Texas, including in 2013 when the Department of Public Safety, you might remember this one, was forced to pay $185,000 to two women who troopers had conducted cavity searches by the roadside, illuminated by patrol car headlights in full view of passing traffic. You remember that one? We talked about that here on Free Talk Live. That one was caught on video.
Did they propose that they had marijuana up there too?
They thought they had something up there. Police in Texas came under renewed scrutiny last month over the case of Sandra Bland, an African-American woman found dead in her jail cell after being detained during a traffic stop. So that's there's not much more there on that on this particular case.
I don't know what's Sandra Bland, how she's related to this other than she's a woman. I mean, you know, she wasn't strip searched on the side of the road like these ladies were.
Was she pulled over for driving while black?
I think she rolled through a stop sign. Well,
that's what happened in this case.
I can't remember what happened with Sandra Bland, but it was minor. I think it was a failure to use a turn signal.
So there you go. Yet another example of police misconduct here. There's just no shortage of these stories. We could fill an entire show with this stuff. And in fact, Derrick J. generally does that every Wednesday night on Cop Block Radio. And you can join him. Go to TheDerrickJ.com. You can find past episodes, I suspect.
Yep, links are all there.
Through that website. And of course, you can listen to it live on Wednesday nights on LRN.FM. TheDerrickJ.com. It has been Free Talk Live. We'll be back tomorrow night. Join us online in the meantime at FreeTalkLive.com. And don't consent to searches, ever. Are you?
Fact. The new NSA data center in Utah requires 1.7 million gallons of water every single day to operate. Billions of Fourth Amendment violations need massive computers and the water to cool them. That water is being supplied by the state of Utah. Fact, there's absolutely nothing in the Constitution which requires your state to help the feds violate your rights. Our message to Utah? Turn it off. No water equals no NSA data center. Visit offnow.org.
If you want to play online poker with Bitcoin, you need a site that's trustworthy and technically sound. The site managers of swcpoker.eu have proven their commitment to bringing you great gameplay from a site you can trust, swcpoker.eu. They have lots of new games too, including Chinese poker, and their Krill leaderboard is open right now. It's a beautiful site, easy to use with lots of players. Go on over to swcpoker.eu now and have some fun with your Bitcoin. swcpoker.eu.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Monday, August 17th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.31 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,119 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $259. Antiwar.com reports, while Iraqi officials continue to downplay the difficulty of turning the tables on the Islamic State, which has captured much of the country's western border with Syria, the government's primary efforts seem to be passing around blame for the major defeats of the war so far. Iraqi Prime Minister Haider Abadi has been loudly critical of the military for the loss of the Anbar capital of Ramadi, saying the troops fled despite orders to stay and defeat the Islamic State. On Sunday, he ordered the commanders court-martialed for abandoning their defensive positions and losing the city. They're not alone in facing blame, however, as the Iraqi parliament has issued a report blaming a number of former government officials, including former Prime Minister Nouri al-Maliki, for the loss of Mosul, the largest city to fall to the Islamic State. In both cases, the underlying assumption is that the battles could have been won if the troops had simply followed the orders to win those battles, and Maliki is facing blame for installing commanders who weren't willing to win the Battle of Mosul. Though it was a surprise how quickly the military lines broke in Mosul, the loss of Ramadi shouldn't have been nearly so surprising, as the poor morale among Iraqi forces was already well documented, and it was clear they simply weren't going to stand up to a sustained the Islamic State offensive.
For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
UPI reports at least one person has died so far and many homes have been burned to the ground as four wildfires spread in the western United States. The blazes, burning in drought-ravaged California, Oregon, Washington, and Idaho, have wrought havoc on miles of acreage in recent days. The largest, the so-called Soda Fire, has so far burned nearly 300,000 acres, and the state's Lawyer Complex Fire has so far destroyed more than 50 homes, according to officials. A woman died Friday as she was preparing to flee the wildfire, according to officials, and authorities believe she fell and injured her head. Idaho's governor declared a state of emergency in part of that state. In California, the Cabin Fire, which was sparked Saturday, is approaching 2,000 acres and is 20% contained. In Oregon, 35,000 acres of land have been torched by the lightning-caused Canyon Creek Complex Fire, and more than 100 structures have been destroyed in Washington state. Weather conditions affected by the fires vary across each of the states, and officials said air quality is at its worst levels in some places.
Are you an advocate for free market money? Do you promote Bitcoin as an alternative in a fiat-centric world? Then you need Spendabit in your arsenal, the search engine for things you can buy with Bitcoin. Spendabit aggregates millions of products from thousands of Bitcoin-enabled merchants. Keep your money in the free economy. Visit spendabit.co today. Bitcoin merchants, ask about our merchant suite to reach even more customers. Spendabit.co. Reuters reports Greece's socialist PASOK party joined the main opposition on Sunday in saying it would not back Prime Minister Alexis Tsipras if he calls a confidence vote following a rebellion in the governing party over a new bailout deal. Tsipras had to rely on opposition groups, including PASOK, to win a parliamentary majority on Friday in favor of the 86 billion euro bailout program, Greece's third with international creditors since 2010. By contrast,